real match.
Yeah.
Although you were missing. Aristus is saying, Food, yeah. You could stay also if you were so inclined.
I like violence. I call the lady, though.
Okay, so you're staying with Polonius, and you're going to...
He says, I gotta go to the bathroom.
Yes.
Well, I mean, he's speaking in his head.
Although, I act also over... Can I, like, cast over the phone call Detect Scrying?
I don't think you can cast things through the phone.
I'm sorry, you can't do that.
Can I spend a mythic point to do that?
No.
There's a spell I have that prevents scrying.
Why are you going to try and prevent... Who are you trying to prevent from scrying you?
I don't know.
Me!
I'm gonna talk to him about us, like, putting a
just
person on.
Just covering your ass?
Yeah.
Bones McJangles.
Well, the... spell that would prevent scrying would just prevent people from scrying on you as you do that. They wouldn't be able to tap your phone line because there is none.
Ah, excellent. Then I call the lady.
Okay. Do you cast the anti-scrying spell first, or...?
No, because I just don't want them to be able to hear the phone conversation. They can look at me if they want to.
With a banana to your ear?
Yeah. Banana phone. Because I'm technically not even talking, I'm thinking it.
Mm. Champion Urab.
Our party is in a situation where, so the emperor is, you probably know about this, but the emperor is dying and there's three heirs. One of them's a buffoon, one of them is shrewd, but kind of probably will fight Ardani at some point. Another one is very fat, which I guess isn't important now that I think about it.
That's his main characteristic.
But he might be, he seems interested in the beast, the cult, and possibly combating it, or maybe, I don't know, just interested.
He's just saying that to placate us.
True, yeah. So we're in this, basically, do we engage, or are you going to tell me, like, we're in a better position to make that decision?
Well, honestly, you are in a better position to make that decision. As far as I can tell from Dominium, from what I've been hearing, that the Emperor is ill in some fashion,
yes.
Imminently dying.
Yeah.
The story that I've been getting.
Just like that.
Which would mean that Princess Domitia is the one who will likely take the throne after him. If you don't think that she should, then you should probably take steps to prevent that.
Okay, so...
I can take the dying.
Not on paper, no signature, but rubber stamp. You can fuck with the Empire if you want.
The Queen will know nothing.
Yes, gotcha. If we're caught, we're dead.
This is fucking Black Ops? Jesus.
Yeah, this is some COD Blops.
We're the Black Ops division of the Champions of Ardania now.
Uh-huh.
I put blackface on my face.
God, that's not the right word for it.
I'm pretty sure they call it blackface.
Thank you, Nuva.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Aristus is undercover now.
Would it be better to put a fool on the throne or a competent person on the throne?
We likely need all the powers to be potent for the coming battle against the beast that rides. So I'd prefer if Prince Aurelius was not in charge.
Okay. Polonius then.
Polonius will just maintain the status quo, I think. Unless he's, like, fooling us.
Well. Oh.
Wait. I don't understand. Polonius isn't an imbecile?
No.
Polonius does not appear to be an imbecile. Oh,
he's got her number, too.
Holy shit.
Not so good of a spy master.
We should have just killed her.
The spy master.
I've met Prince Polonius personally.
Oh, maybe someone is pretending to
he
be Prince Polonius.
Pretty stupid.
How stupid?
You're not actually there, Silva.
I pretend I'm there.
I pretend I'm there, and I talk like I am.
I expend the mythic point to make this a conference
join
call.
Join my long-distance call?
I also spend
a mythic
point
to make this a conference call.
Silva picks up another phone that's connected by landline.
By phone, you mean banana.
Banana. One of those landline bananas.
Can a Tancat attempt to order a pizza?
I call up Al's... Chemical Emporium.
Instead, you hear Prince Polonius on the other end of the line. Yes, hello. Is this a service for the calloused working man I ordered?
No, this is a service for the nubile slave boys.
Oh, God, no, no, no!
No, I already have those.
You're using up my minutes.
Unless you can connect me to the other thing, I think I'll just be in my room.
It's hours, idiot. Jesus.
Hang up and dial operator. Jesus.
One moment, please. Hang on. And then
okay, we stop making fucking phone jokes.
But I want to just jostle the phone.
It's gonna go on for like the next hour if we let it.
Yes, it will. So we should probably stop.
Okay, so to you, Polonius was a fool. How you've you met him personally? Are you suspicious that this might not be Polonius that we've spoken to, or that Polonius has played you?
Describe who Polonius, what Polonius looked like.
Really, 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 really fat.
That fits the bill.
Like the Baron Harkonnen.
Like immobile.
Immobile.
Well, yes, that's him then.
I mean,
he how did he act to you that makes you think he's competent?
He just seemed kind of shrewd, and like he started questioning us about the beast that rise from the get-go, and
don't forget he also straight up told you that he likes to act like a buffoon around most people.
Yeah. I don't recall that, but that too.
Fruit was missing. Polonius at one point referenced how
I hand the phone to Atenket.
Yeah, Atenket just stares at the banana.
We're just gonna pass the phone around.
Hey, Lady Erlyn, I'm Atenket.
You don't know who she is.
Who are you?
Hi, Erlyn. Just sitting here thinking. I don't know. What are you up to?
Can I get a raid?
Stop it with these phone references. These are anachronistic.
What you wearing?
Shouts Castellarius.
I'm wearing hand the phone back to Urab.
Hold on. Urab wants to talk to you. I'm going to put him on.
I'm wearing that with
feather
and nothing else.
Oh, shit. I accidentally hit the hang-up thing.
Oh, whoops. It's on speakerphone. Polonius can hear you. God damn it. Okay, so...
How embarrassing.
We would prefer a competent empire, and Domitia doesn't seem antagonistic towards Ardania so much as just, like, militaristic and probably would, you know, because it's...
Well, remember, the person who told us she was, like, antagonistic towards, where are we from? Ardania. It was Polonius himself.
Well, I also remember Domitia talking about how, like, it would be great to face us in battle.
Yeah.
So everybody.
I don't remember that at all.
She did.
That happened.
Well.
You weren't listening.
Yeah. So, Polonius?
I will let you decide. But we have no knowledge of your actions.
How's the evac going? Oh, I guess I called you just, like, literally 20 minutes prior, didn't I? You know, Time Oracle. I get my timelines all messed up.
Remind me, evacuation?
Man, it feels like it's been a week, doesn't it? Weird.
Remind me, evacuation?
Oh, to get us out of here.
Oh, right.
That thing.
When's our evac
time? No, that wasn't Erlyn. That was me. I actually didn't.
No, I know.
No, I like it being Erlyn. Like, oh, wait, did I say I was going to do it? Oh, right.
We are arranging for you transport by ship.
Cool. Is it with a certain surly Italian?
No.
Oh.
Given our continued relationship with the Vivanese and your activities in Domitia, it would be prudent to not involve the...
The new trade prince's brother.
Yes.
So it's just going to be like some smelly fishmonger.
Yeah, no. We are, as I said, arranging it currently.
Halflings.
It's an invasion.
Invade them first. Team. Can't fail.
It's soap and ghost. And the other people in Coblops.
What other people?
I don't know.
Also, that's actually... in Modern Warfare, you idiot.
Modern Warfare, I'm sorry.
No.
No Ardanian. Remember, no Ardanian. or rather, remember, no Domitian. Okay, I guess that's it. Do you want us to pick you up anything nice from Domitia?
Domitium.
Domitium?
No, thank you. It's quite all right.
TTYL.
Have a good
Love
time.
You, bye.
Okay, bye. All right,
now that you're done with your mythic sending.
Okay. I guess I'm with on the Polonius place.
Team Polonius?
Team Polonius. It's not the easiest path. But I don't know. I like the cut of his jib.
What's a jib?
It's the sail at the front of a boat that allows you to steer it.
Okay.
Alright, so currently Aristus and Urab are on Team Polonius. Emiria is on Team Domitia.
Isn't a Tim Kid also with Polonius?
Yeah. No, I'm Team Aurelius. He seems pretty reasonable.
Yeah, Team Aurelius, man.
Fuck the police.
I mean, I'm all for Team Emiria, but since apparently she wasn't born in Domitia and she can't produce a birth certificate.
Domitia is that lady. The Domitium is the city. The Dumedain Empire is the country.
Right. I'm on the team of us finding out if the Emperor is actually dying or not.
That seems like a decent idea. Anyway.
The robot is being logical again.
Guys!
Yes?
What's being logical again?
That doesn't sound like us.
Okay, let's find out.
Time to, like, I put on my investigation hat.
Alright. I'm still with Polonius.
Urab and Aristus stay at Prince Polonius's.
No, just Urab.
Stay
no one wanted to come with me.
Like, we also had this discussion last week where we all were like not wanting to stay with Aristus.
Well, I wasn't staying either way. So.
Yeah, same.
It's like, oh, what's Aristus doing? I'm doing the opposite.
That was more you.
I know.
Yeah, I'm with Polonius. I'm like, is your dad actually sick?
My father is unfortunately on death's door. It is truly, truly tragic.
I'm gonna mute myself.
His failure to conquer the Dwarven High Kingdom sapped his strength and will to live.
The Star Wars 3 illness.
Also, the dottores say that he has severe cancer.
Well,
a little different.
He's got
the healers have done everything they can, but it appears that my aged father is simply at the end of his life.
Oh, so sad, so sorry.
Are you like quoting most popular girls in high school?
He's got
you watched those, Nuva?
I had to look that up.
Mallory convinced me to watch, and it's one of my favorite things ever.
That's incredible.
He's like the king of Rohan.
Yeah.
Wait, who's talking in his ear? Who's this worm tongue?
You don't know. Maybe it's one of the three people that you have to choose between.
Well, I don't think it's Polonius, because I don't think he can get to his dad's ear.
There's too much stuff in the way.
Too much of him in the way.
Prince Polonius was arrested for accidentally smothering his father while attempting to whisper in his ear.
Father, come closer. I must speak to you. And then his father climbs up his fat folds.
They put a ladder up against him.
The dumbest bit I've ever heard.
Yeah.
I don't know why Polonius had the little orphan boy voice. But I'm not regretting it.
Father, come closer to my ear.
Anyway, so, Urav and Aristus, you are currently at Polonius' side. He has ordered chairs to be brought up to you and placed in positions of honor to his right.
Cool.
I would like to have the furthest seat away from Polonius.
I get up right next to that thing.
It's not like he smells bad.
How? What bathtub fits him?
A big one.
That's why he has nubile slave boys, idiot.
Yeah, they rub him.
This is why the prestidigitation spell exists.
Yeah. The only reason. The person who invented it, a little known fact, was a very, very fat guy. He had to clean himself.
Yes. They called him Stinky Pete.
Stinky Pete.
Until he invented the spell.
Prestidigitation. But it's, at that point everybody called him that, so
Speaking
it kind
of
stuck.
Stinky Pete, is Pete in this call?
I am, but I'm kind of sleepy from last night and everything.
Works in Stinky Pete.
Okay.
Oh, wait, no, you're Sleepy Pete right now. Aw.
Adorable.
What were you doing last night?
Seriously.
It turned out it wasn't actually Thanksgiving I was going to, but a very early Christmas.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
I don't get that. What, do you time travel to different months?
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's an early Thanksgiving.
White people, man, they celebrate Christmas like 3 months early now.
Next week.
Oh no, why not?
Thanksgiving.
Canadian Thanksgiving.
Canadian Thanksgiving.
Wait, what?
We'll all be here.
Canadian Thanksgiving is a different time.
It's in October.
I'm glad you appreciate the unintended hilarity of Canadian Thanksgiving, but
yeah,
I won't be with my computer.
Yeah, it never occurred to me that the Canadians probably screwed the Native Americans on Thanksgiving on a different date.
Jeez. No, it was more so the French people.
Anyway.
So Quebec or whatever.
Quebec.
Quebec.
What? Quebec. Are you trying to say Quebec?
He is trying to say Quebec.
I never looked up a Canadian city spelling. Okay, shut up.
It's a province.
It's a province, and it's not that complicated. It's just
Quebec City is a city in the province. But,
you know how to say Queen, right? Like Kiev, not like Q.
I know that there's a Nova Scotia or whatever.
Nova Scotia.
it's Nova Scotia.
Now you're just making shit up.
And the Northwest territories.
And I'm never sure if Montreal is in Canada or Paris. France.
Holy shit!
This is bad.
My God.
This is bad, and I don't like listening to it.
Most American thing I've heard Nuva do.
You know, ironically, is like an incredibly good American.
He's out Americaning the rest of us right now.
I'm sorry that I'm more socially conscious than that fuckhead.
Yeah, what kind of American are you? You're supposed to be repping Florida.
I'm sorry, Florida man was shot by a puppy, so I can't really,
Florida man cannot die.
But he was shot by a puppy.
I saw, but he cannot die.
We've already said that Florida man lives, dies, and lives again.
He is the basis for
Morton Joel, that was his name.
And Morton... Morton Billy Joel Armstrong.
This session.
Man, remember how we got nothing done this session?
Yeah.
Nope. We're watching this cool thing.
Oh no, let's go back to the phone jokes. Those were kind of old.
Anyway. So you're brought up in positions of power, positions of honor right next to Prince Polonius.
Power, huh?
Yes. He's raised us like one of his own.
You are given, you are offered ample food and drink from his private stores.
Right. Is it in his privates?
No!
A drink.
You done?
No.
She's looks like a hyena.
This session has been 75% Nuva laughing.
Yeah, it has.
All right, guys, don't be funny anymore. We can't have Nuva laugh anymore.
We're not even funny. That's the best part.
Yeah, it's just like, hey, Canadian Thanksgiving.
Okay, that's the fact that he laughed at that made it funny.
Anyway. And as you're sitting there preparing to watch the show in Polonius Coasting, I think you shall like this one very much. You see, one of the gladiators is a Gilman, like yourself.
Oh, cool. I've never seen another one of my... Wait, no, yeah, I've seen...
I have never seen another Gilman in my entire life.
Really strange.
That's my Nuva.
Could you never fucking do that again?
Tell that to Nuva.
It was much more annoying coming from you.
I'm not talking about.
I'm not kidding. It was a lot louder. It was a lot higher pitched.
Oh my god. We're not going to do anything this session, you guys.
On with the show.
Where'd you find him? Is he from... What's the name of that city that Jake was a manta ray in?
Throne.
Throne?
And it's the manta ray? Thank you.
Whatever.
Hmm? Oh, no, he's not Aldanian. He was enslaved somewhere in the Empire.
Cool.
Since then, he has become a rather good star attraction in the Western arenas. And I'm told he is quite effective with his trident and net.
I'm sorry, what?
I said that he is quite effective with his trident and net.
Keep perpetuating those racial stereotypes, buddy. Thumbs up.
Huh. He's good with a trident, huh? I guess we'll see.
Dude.
I want Nuva to jump in here.
Petition to...
Like, just jump in the ring.
Petition to swap Aristus with this Gilman.
Is his name Maximus Decimus Meridius?
No.
Father to a dead son? Or mother to a dead wife.
Is he
no,
Aquaman?
Shit. Father
to a dead wife.
Husband.
He was.
Hey, we're progressive here.
Much more different movie than I remember.
God, Gladiator's a good movie.
What does he call himself?
Hmm? Oh, his name is... it's so hard to remember. We go through so many here. But I believe it's Hanan, something along those lines. Anyway, you'll be finding some new minotaur whose owner is apparently just not particularly well invested in him, since I sincerely doubt he's going to survive very long. But it should be bloody, and that should make it entertaining at least.
Yes, I agree.
Of course.
Can we bet money?
Of course.
Alright.
Jump! I shall come! My favorite bookkeeper shall attend to your betting.
I bet Aristus's life on the life of the Minotaur.
Oh, come on.
The bookkeeper scribbles that down.
Great.
What's the ratio or whatever?
2 copper.
Give me the odds here.
I like the 6-1 odds that the
odds. Yeah, that's what
wins.
I like that down low insult there, Rob.
Thanks.
I'll put 1,000 gold on the Gilman then.
You would get 166 then.
Yep.
Yeah.
Right. Yep.
And if it's an upset, you're out 8,000 gold.
Yeah. Oh.
Do you understand how betting works?
No, it's legal in Islam.
No, it's not. He does not out. He put down 1,000 on that one, so that means he'd lose 1,000 or he'd get 166.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's, okay, if that's not what I said, that's what I meant.
I actually do not understand betting at all.
Well don't like, do it. Come then. On, man. Like, you've read books.
Yeah,
you've watched the World Poker Championship.
You've fucking math.
You've played Animal Crossing.
Yeah, gambling's it's easy.
Yeah,
just like this.
Just do it,
father.
But anyway, you're doing so. You're doing the safe bet, and the upswing is that if that Gilman wins, you're going to get 166 gold out of it,
and cool. You live.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, wait. No, if you if
are
the Gill Man wins,
if the
you
Minotaur
die.
Dies, he dies, and if the Minotaur lives, he lives. Is that the bet?
Yeah. Well, and also, shit, does that mean we get six Aristuses if the Minotaur wins?
Oh, no.
Can you cancel your bet before it...
I cancel my bet. Never mind, take away that bet. I don't want
the bookie,
six of it.
scratches it out and nods at you and walks away.
Does he nod sagely?
Dodge a bullet.
Anyway, the rest of you. Silva, Odell, Etenket, Emiria, also Castellarius and Crozumazin. Actually, Castellarius will be staying with Urabuni. So Castellarius is in fact with Urab.
I mean, he could be like, I want to go shopping.
Yeah.
I need to go shopping!
Castellarius and Crozumazin are having their own spin-off episode.
Oh, wait, should I have leveled Castellarius too?
No.
No.
Cohorts gain experience at a weird rate, right?
Cohorts do gain experience, but Castellarius is a monstrous cohort, and he is just generally weird.
Okay.
Yeah, he's a weird one.
Mr. Okay. Grinch.
So, the rest of you. Emiria, Silva, Castellarius, Odell, and Etenket.
I'd take Castellarius with you.
Alright, and Castellarius, and Crozumazin. Exit the arena. As you're exiting, you hear the drums and trumpets from within the arena heralding the next fight, and a great roar as the people welcome the fighters.
This place is weird.
I'm sure that most Dumidians would say the same thing about Ardania.
No. Fuck them.
Retorts. The gendarme lieutenant who is waiting for you outside of the arena with her hands clasped behind her back.
What are you keeping behind there?
Yeah, that's true.
Can't What's your charisma?
Hmm?
What's the gendarme's charisma?
How would you know?
How good looking is she?
The next question, is she hot?
She's actually relatively plain.
Oh, a butterface.
She's not ugly. She's not particularly beautiful. She's just sort of... She's her own person. She's happy with it.
Hey, man, I'm down to clown with them playing girls.
I'm still fucking
down,
like,
trying to start...
If you're actually saying this to her, then... Wait, are you actually saying this?
Roll for initiative.
That doesn't fit in line with the 10K at all.
Castellarius reaches out and puts a shoulder on a 10K. Puts a hand on a 10K's shoulder.
Puts
the like,
whole shoulder on my shoulder.
He's like, come on, man.
Man.
I peered into the waves of time and I saw this is not a good idea.
I frown. I look down and I say I'm sorry. I say I'm sorry to the judge. You're very lovely.
Thank
you. Cat is like easy there.
Cat, stop being weird.
Keep in mind, guys,
you're
a dog. 3 years old.
He's also a dog.
Silva's
so he
also 3 years
falls
old.
In love with people 100% and completely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They've been magically aged, dude.
Me and a 10-kid are like 3 year olds. Three-year-old brothers, I don't know.
Oh, yeah. You and Kat are basically little baby
socially
children.
Retarded?
Me, let's go to, like, I don't know, toddler school.
Okay, don't talk to me about socially retarded, Nuva.
That's too much. Too much, Jake.
I wasn't saying Nuva wasn't saying.
Okay.
That's kind of where you were going.
That you used my name!
Yeah, well, I'm not talking to Arisus. I was talking to...
Anyway,
that being said, Nuva is also socially retarded.
What the hell is happening here? What happened to Pathfinder?
Don't know. Jake's being mean.
Yes, he is. Stop. Anyway, where the hell was I? I forgot now.
We were seeing the lieutenant.
We were leaving, and we heard like the trumpets and the Colosseum, the mirror, and, kind of like, eh. And then Gemcat was like, "Is she hot?" That's where we were.
Yeah, butterface.
getting to the real important question.
Yes. Anyway. So, the gendarme lieutenant is currently just standing there with her have hands clasped behind her back, looking at you impassively. What do you do?
I nod.
Back. Are you supposed to guide us some particular place?
My, in so far as where you ask me to take you, I will lead you. I am, in fact, your guide.
Is it possible to get audience with the Emperor?
Yeah. Not at this time. The Emperor is very ill.
I heard. That's a shame.
She does not respond.
Not a big Emperor fan, are you?
She continues to not respond.
Good call.
She is utterly stone-faced.
Totally stoned.
Man. That reminds Temcat me, today, Root
was
Boy,
the, today was the pot festival in Madison.
That sounds cool.
Did you get high?
No, but I walked through like a plume of smoke. I got a contact high.
Nice.
Nice.
I was boarding. I could do that by walking down the hallway sometimes.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yep.
Nice.
Shut up.
Stop it. It's getting silly.
Okay, so
do we just want to go back?
Should we go try to find information on like that could slander? Well, okay, I'm saying this out of earshot of what's her face.
Do you order her to actually stay back, or?
Actually, no. That would seem too suspicious. I ask her to take us back to our, like, hotel room?
Yeah. Let's go back to our hotel.
The palace?
Yes. Sure.
Yeah, Hotel Palace.
The Palace Hotel.
Yes. Yeah, that sounds like...
As you wish. We will go by foot. Follow me, please.
Okay.
She turns on her heel and starts walking away. Down the street.
I follow suit by turning on my heel as well.
You begin walking back towards the arena.
I follow normally. Weird.
Yeah, I follow.
All right. She leads you into the bustle of the city. Very rapidly. People park before her, but not so much before you. And it's a little difficult for you to keep up with her, trying to stay in the wake of people who are just getting the hell out of her way. As you would think that it is safe to communicate amongst yourselves while you're at this distance with the amount of noise around you. If you want to actually hold a conversation, because I know... Jake, you wanted to actually say something, but then you realize that there's a guard right next to you.
I mean, should we, like, go investigate into Prince Domitia? Or Princess Domitia?
Like, the voice what? Carries through the wind and like, says, break into the Emperor's room.
I believe we should investigate into the Emperor's illness to determine if it's actually true or not.
Break into his room.
I'm fairly certain that it probably is. If Lady Erlyn, like, she's, like, as good a spymaster as you said.
She didn't know Polonius wasn't dumb.
Whatever.
But I believe that she knows if the Emperor is actually sick or not.
That's a little better.
Some credit. She's not, she's not inept.
Yeah. But I'm just saying maybe your information about Domitia... God damn it. Domitium is outdated.
Yeah, but how are we going to get in? I'm pretty sure if the Emperor is still living and he's sick, the guards there are going to be more alert than anywhere else.
Set the palace on fire.
You're not here.
Set the palace on fire!
I summon Urob here.
I don't like how you're immediately siding against Domitia just because Polonius said... That's a little off-putting.
Dumidia, well, I told you, we also had, before we even met Polonius, Dumidia mentioned multiple times about how she would like to see Ardania on the field of battle, that it would be glorious.
I mean,
you're also not here.
the way I see it, you know, Polonius wants to directly fight against the Bessarides and also doesn't seem to want to attack your home nation. So, isn't that kind of a win-win for you? Wouldn't you rather have the person who's not going to attack you?
Well, he says he's not going to attack us, but, like, he's a deceitful guy. That much has been made perfectly clear
to us. That is correct.
Well, you
also,
take a
chance. Also, I do not like the Dumidian Empire.
Fuck him.
Nobody does.
Beep boop.
But I mean, like,
Silvis still offers Castellarius. Having a strong Dumidian Empire at the time that the Beast of Rise decides to try and eat everything would probably be, like, prudent.
Are we talking about the Empire or Polonius?
The Empire.
The Empire okay. is Polonius.
I am the state.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I heard the word eat, and I'm like, oh.
What? Oh, I guess.
Basically, what I'm saying is, based on the impression we're given right now, Polonius is aware of the threat of the Beast that arrives. Princess
Dumidia.
Dumidia.
Princess Dumi.
Oldies.
I'm just calling her Princess
Dumi. She is so far completely written off the threat of the Beast that arrives. And I mean, she said it herself that she doesn't think it's that big a deal.
Plus, she wants to kill us.
She does not want to kill us.
She wants to fight us.
She said she wants to face Ardania in the field of battle, but I already talked about that. Keep up. You're not here. Now, so the way I see it, she doesn't take the threat seriously, so what if the Beast of Rise arrives, and she's like, oh, you guys fucking handle it yourselves. Fuck Ardania. And then she just doesn't bring in the Dumidian Empire into it until it's too late.
Isn't the Beast that Rod's most likely going to invade the entire world?
Well, yeah, but wouldn't it stand to reason that the Beast that Rod would also try to take out the people that have stood against them longest first? Instead of giving them time to plan by spreading out and attacking many places at once?
Maybe that is why it's building its forces now, so it can attack the entire world at one time.
Maybe what we want to do right now is go talk to Princess Dees.
Exactly.
I mean, yeah, that's fine. I'd like to. If my only thing is, as I said, she has pretty much stated that she completely has written off the whole threat, and that's an issue. We don't need somebody who's written off the threat. Don't try to fuck me.
Castellarius shrugs.
Oh, it would be illegal.
Yes, isn't that bestiality?
Well, it's because he's 3 years old.
That too.
True.
It does actually raise a number of legal questions. None of which I feel like contemplating at this time.
No, let's get into this. Let's really dig in.
I rolled knowledge law check.
Knowledge law check. That's what it's called, right?
Yes.
Can you also find out if you can fuck your own clone?
Well, of course you can.
As you're walking along...
That's just science.
Dumidia has stopped walking in front of you.
Dumidia?
Excuse me. The lieutenant has stopped walking in front of you.
She reveals that she's Princess Dumidia the whole time.
No, she's not. She's okay. Really not.
But she is!
Okay, sorry.
This lieutenant is a much more slightly built and quite a bit shorter than Princess Dumidia.
Is she hot?
Stop asking
me. I'm kidding.
Stop that.
Not really, though. I'm kidding, but seriously.
You know what? I'm just going to start answering yes to everyone. Like, if you ask if Prince Polonius is...
Can I have...
And he goes, nice.
Can I have powered armor?
No.
Powdered armor? Sure.
Can I make powered armor for a ten kit?
No.
Damn.
Stop.
Is Polonius just a black hole under a layer of fat?
Clearly not. Then collapsing instead of expanding.
Science.
What's so the name of the emperor?
The emperor's name is Hectorus.
Hectorus Domitius?
Actually,
Is this, because I'm looking at their thing on the background here, based off of the Holy Roman Empire?
The Dumanine Empire, I will let you decide what empire they're based off of.
Alexander's.
Not Alexander's. That thing collapsed in 2 days.
Okay, of the various empires, it's probably least based on Alexander's empire. Okay, how about this? I didn't base the Dumanine Empire on any one specific empire.
I got you. I'm trying to compose a national anthem.
I have I have picked and chosen different aspects of real-world empires and combined them into this new creation.
Super
Mamluk Empire.
Yes, exactly. Actually, no, not the Mamluks.
It's the Marmaduke Empire.
That's a big fucking dog. Wow.
Best punchline in comic history.
That's their national anthem.
That's a big fucking dog.
Followed by wow, and then
you salute.
Okay, so what did she stop for?
The crowd has thickened into pretty much a solid wall of people directly in front of you.
Damn, someone cast wall of people.
As the avenue has filled up as pretty much an obstruction of people looking towards a man on a rickety looking scratch built stage.
I look.
He is quite young looking, and he is currently shouting about inalienable rights and freedoms and the abolition of slavery.
Yeah, I can get behind this.
He looks to be at about student age.
Oh, like, well, this is
maybe
not going to end well.
19 or 20. There are a number of other students with him. They are currently handing out pamphlets to the people in the front that are being passed around to the back. The lieutenant is completely stone-faced about this. And she turns to you and goes, "This might be difficult to get through. Would you mind attempting side paths to get around? I warn you, some of the alleys in this section of the city can be dangerous."
I think we're capable enough. We can
dangerous.
Afford to do that.
I make cold fingers.
Like, what kind of danger are we talking about? Like,
they'll pull out guns and try to shoot
level 17 wizards. Yeah. Push you.
You are attacked by a squad of D4 Shoggoths.
No, you are attacked by the Beast that Rides.
He's holding his step sideways.
You came to the wrong neighborhood.
You turn the corner. You're faced with a Gru.
Man, they really got to get things together in Doom and Team.
His allies just really are not safe.
Mm. That actual cannibal Shia LaBeouf.
Anyway.
Wait. But yeah, I think we'll be fine. Especially with you here with us. Like, I'm not worried.
You're so big and strong.
Yeah.
I appreciate your confidence. But, and she turns to start moving through the crowd and is actually finding that the crowd is sort of pressing in from your rear now, too. It's actually becoming kind of... She's clearly growing aggravated. Like, the wide berth that the various citizens were giving her before is rapidly shrinking.
I'll
try to press in to listen to the speech of the guy.
Hang on. I might have a thing for this.
A Tev Cat pulls out some knives. Stabs them. Or, you know, a gun.
The lieutenant turns back towards the stage and looks at him.
One moment.
And looks at the speaker and goes, "Oh, that's why."
Who is it?
I apologize. The man on the stage is a well-known political agitator that has so far managed to avoid any sort of actual sedition, so the state cannot arrest him.
I could disperse the cloud if you want.
Doing what?
Crowd.
The cloud.
My vambraces of the Shaitan can cast glitter dust.
Ew.
You want to magically fascinate these guys away from us?
Blind them. It blinds them.
That's
with
not
litter.
A good idea.
I could just cast confusion.
I appreciate your suggestion, but the current... But I'd appreciate if you left magical crowd control to the authorities.
To the trained professionals.
I'm going to look at one of these pamphlets.
The pamphlet is mostly abolitionist. And also a regaining of rights that had been abrogated under the last couple of emperors.
Mm-hmm. Look at this guy.
Reinvesting more power in the Dumadin Senate from the emperor.
Mm-hmm. I nod and read.
The lieutenant looks at you disapprovingly.
I nod at her.
And read. And read.
She actually frowns.
Well, hey, she's not stone faced for once.
I'm afraid we might be stuck here for a few moments. It might actually just be if it continues to press in from behind like this, it might actually be faster simply to push our way through.
I
whatever you think is best.
So I can start pushing. Is that cool? I have your permission.
Do not.
I'm not going to hurt people, I promise.
I will not inflict the hurt.
As you wish. Lead the way.
You
need to get to the other side of this crowd.
Attack Cat pulls out some nunchucks.
I flex my big, meaty dog muscles, and then I just...
I'm very glad you said muscles.
That's not where I thought that was going.
And I start making way.
Oh, all right. Well, you are larger and stronger than the average person, so people are just sort of just being pushed out of the way by you.
Well, I'm larger than most.
They go flying in the air.
I'm actually stronger than most people. I have a strength of like 26.
Mm. Right. So yeah, you're just sort of muscling your way through the crowd,
flying through the air.
The occasional child goes flying through the air.
Yeah, fuck them.
The lieutenant is following behind you, occasionally shouting "Move back!" at people who are trying to refill the space that you're leaving behind you. And you actually start making pretty good headway.
But then...
Shut up.
Then we turn the corner. There's a group.
Yes. You turn the corner and it is quite dark. You are likely to be eaten by a group.
Question.
What?
What's a Gru?
Gru is a monster from the game. What's it called?
Zork.
Zork. Okay. Which is a adventure game. Where
text-based.
A text-based adventure game.
I know what Zork is. I kept thinking, like, are you guys saying we're gonna get eaten by a tree or something?
No,
we're gonna get eaten by Gru from Zork. The Despicable Me.
Yes.
All right, carry on. I'm learning all kinds of things today. Canadian Thanksgiving.
Truly, this has been a truly learning Pathfinder session. Yeah.
Revelatory Pathfinder session.
Yeah.
When there, you hear a bit of a commotion coming from the stage.
I look at the commotion.
The rest of you all turn to look. Actually,
okay.
Just make perception checks. You are trying to see over a crowd.
Let's see here.
The lieutenant is quite obviously trying to like sort of hop in place to see over people's shoulders.
Yeah, Miria.
Let me roll.
Miria, you Emiria, you actually see something entirely different than what I'm talking about.
What do I see? Let's get to that first.
You see the Beats and Rides.
No, you see that there's some, like, Dumadine guy, like, checking out at Tent Cat, like, on the other side of the crowd.
He's making eyebrows going,
I make a really face. I'm like, really? Completely oblivious to whatever else is happening.
The rest of you see what people are yelling about, in that a man, a Imperial gendarme, in fact, has leapt up onto the stage and is currently pointing a pistol at the speaker. The lieutenant is demanding to know what the hell is going on because she really can't see anything.
I let her know. Hey, you want to go on my shoulders?
What?
So you can see.
Yes, fine.
I lift her up on my shoulders in the most respectful way possible.
I'm now wondering who else thinks the Temcat is hot.
You?
No.
What is he doing? This isn't... before she's even able to get the sentence out, a loud crack is heard.
Oh.
Do I need to roll perception on this?
Yes, you could roll perception on that. No, you can hear the sound gun going off. And the guy clutches his chest, his glasses fall off his face, and he slumps forward.
Damn.
No.
The gendarme who shot him runs past the people standing around him, who are now trying to crowd around him, getting to him, and leaps into a window of the building behind the stage.
Oh. Hmm.
Okay. Let me see. Silva wasn't around.
Wow.
Tenkat, you would notice, but Odell, Odell would notice, and a Tenkat would notice. The
okay.
Two following things.
Oh.
Two entirely different things, in fact. A Tenkat, you notice that while the guy was wearing the tri-cornered hat and coat, his shirt and pants look different from what the lieutenant is currently wearing.
I would know that because I was picking her up and got a good look.
To check out dad ass?
Hell yeah.
Odell? I'm sorry.
I was going to ask her, like, how strict their uniform policy is.
Well, this is already sounding a lot like a false flag.
You also saw something different from what I saw, though.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Odell, you didn't notice that.
Oh,
because you were too busy looking at something else.
Dad ass.
Yes, the guy's ass. It's magnificent. No. for one thing, it was covered by a greatcoat. Odell, the guy, despite being from a great distance and you not having, like, the best eyes in the world, being just a human, looked really familiar, particularly his hair, which was a deep but vibrant red.
Wait.
Is this guy dwarf-sized?
No, he's human-sized. In fact, he was a human. You could definitely tell that.
Was Chester red-headed?
No, he had black hair.
I don't remember who had red hair.
It was Bones McJangles.
Nope.
We all know he had a full head of red hair.
Nope.
My God, it all makes sense.
The barbarian kid wasn't...
No.
Redhead. No.
Marco
he's
has
also,
black hair.
We also
Did you say Marco had red hair?
Black.
Mm-hmm. Black hair.
A lot of people with black hair. It's like it's a common color or something.
Yeah.
Okay, hey, Odell, you rolled a 20, so you just recognize him. He looks a lot like Red. The rebel leader from Ardania.
Oh. Yeah, that guy. That's, man, that's a deep cut. Most of the people here don't know him.
Yeah, well, that's a throwback.
Yeah. Yeah.
At this point, it's pretty much just Emiria and... Well, actually...
Myself and you, Jake.
Odell Odell, you were there.
I wouldn't actually, though. Not on
Attend Ket doesn't know who he is.
Well, yeah.
I don't even remember if I was with Emiria then.
Yeah, you were. I'm pretty sure you were.
Yeah, you didn't.
You stopped being Emiria after we saved the queen, and that was before we saved.
That's
the queen.
Right.
Right.
Was he like one of the badass guys that helped us, or is
yes.
this?
Yes.
Remember
he was.
When
yeah.
you were attacking yeah. The Order of the Griffin,
and he just like killed everyone while we did our thing.
Yes.
He was yeah. super badass.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he just shot a student protester.
Why?
Because he's trying to incite a rebellion, because that's what he does. Although I wouldn't know this.
Sounds like a pretty bad dude.
I mean, it's not a good look.
It's not a good look, no.
Going around killing poor little students. I can't relate to that.
Atenket, the weight on your shoulder suddenly seems a lot lighter, as in fact, it no longer exists.
This concerns me.
The lieutenant is no longer on top of your shoulder. She is, in fact, on top of the stage. She has drawn a pistol and is ordering people away from her, away from the man as she tries to get towards him.
It's a sweet vertical leap.
Actually, she's dimension doored.
Oh.
Nice vertical leap, bro.
The crowd is, like, panicking and beginning to become ugly.
I'm gonna dimension door over to Red and just kind of, like...
I think he's already gone.
Oh, Red's already gone?
He jumped through a window.
Oh.
I am actually gonna start going after the direction he went in.
Shoot him.
It's so weird that in a world of magic, guns, like...
kill people?
No. Red people kill people. Specifically Red in this case.
Yeah.
Guns I'll run over the window and I'll look out.
There is a large crowd in front of you, so you're dimension dooring over to there?
Yes.
Alright, you dimension door onto the stage. Do you look through the window?
Yes. A dumb cat, you have to throw me.
What?
Oh, Emiria, what happened to your voice?
Well, the window has shattered due to having a body jumping through it. Make a perception check.
Okay.
Odell, specifically.
Oh. Oh, yeah, he dimension doored.
Okay. I did it.
Good work,
you
Odell.
You can't see him inside the room. It's not dark, but he's definitely not in it. The door, however, on the far side of the room is ajar.
Oh.
The door is ajar.
Alright, I'm just gonna jump down and run towards it.
As you begin to jump down, however, you hear the sound of the crowd yelling behind you gain in loudness, and you also hear your guide shouting, "Get back!" turning, you have seen that people are starting to climb up on the stage and are stalking towards her. She is currently pointing her gun at them, but is being forced to... walk backwards towards your position.
Can I get to her?
You'll have to push the crowd.
I push real hard.
Okay. Just start flopping over in front of you.
Hold up, I'm looking something up. I could throw a wall of ice in front of the stage.
You could.
I could.
Do anything.
Silver dimension, dimension doors to a side, like way
you
area.
You have a dimension door too?
I have a wand of dimension door.
Oh.
Which can you take me to Silva?
Yeah, I grab him and then I
take me with
get
you.
Onto the stage. Then I river of wind a majority of these guys who are about to.
These ruffians.
Ruffians who are about to probably beat her to death.
I mean.
I could just wall it off. You don't have to, like, ripple with people.
Well, but it's core this way.
Yeah, it is non-lethal damage.
Is Silva finally turning on Terminator mode?
No.
I always wanted to see Silva go Terminator mode.
I mean, River of Rend is a non-lethal spell, so I don't think you're going to get to it. You're going to get it.
Oh, I wanted to hear him say, like, really bad Spanish lines.
Well, too bad, I guess.
Don't worry, that day will come.
I hope so. I want to hear you say hasta la vista unironically.
That's Terminator 2, by the way.
Whatever. It's a dream. It doesn't have to be
lemon?
It doesn't have to be lemons.
I'm tired. Shut the fuck up.
Dream. It doesn't have to be lemon.
All right, so you create the River of Wind, creating a 120-foot-long River of Wind.
Yep.
Between the stage and yourself. A number of people are knocked down, actually knocked unconscious by it. And the rest are kind of staying back. But they have started throwing things above the River of Wind and onto the stage.
Oh.
Like bottles and rocks.
Sure. Yeah, you know what? I'm just going to throw up this wall of ice.
Oh, I am still going to jump out the window then. It looks like these guys got everything covered.
All right.
Wall of ice goes up. Wall 20 feet high. How big is the stage? Like, how? What's the length?
Can the stage hold the ice?
How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
I just say, you did say it was a rickety stage.
Yeah, well, it's a 40-foot by 40-foot stage. Emiria, roll a 1d2. The stage collapses under the weight of the ice wall, which shatters as it falls to the ground.
Oh, no.
You are currently all prone, and people are trying to... Yes, you may all attempt acrobatics to avoid being knocked prone, except for Odell, who is currently in the house.
Okay, let me...
He just gets knocked prone.
I roll acrobatics. And I presume Crozy Moz can just, like, fly, so...
All right, you both make it. Crozmasin just sort of flies, yeah. Emiria, you should also roll. Oh, wait, you're not on the stage.
I'm not on the stage.
All right, you're all the way back there. You're currently also starting to be jostled by a very violent crowd. That also just saw you cast a spell. So they're now starting to shout at you.
Well... I actually think I know what I'm going to do.
Okay. Could you each roll initiative? This is not technically combat, but okay. It would help if you were actually on an initiative order.
Okay.
Right. Because, like, we're going by, like, very sad amounts of time, yeah. Okay.
What tab is initiative under again? I cannot never remember. Core?
Front page. Indeed.
Wait, what's the front page?
Core.
Core, okay. I'm just trying to find it. I can't seem to...
It's right beneath health.
Oh, there we go. Okay, yeah. I never remember where it is, so...
Just give me a second. I'm trying to look up.
Angry crowd initiative.
No, not that. I meant to make a POG earlier, but I was busy doing something. Wow. So I ended up not.
Oh.
Which is bad, because now I actually want the POG. Well, this one will be useful. Ah! is this?
What's that?
Am I going to have to make, like, a scan of it from the book? That'd be annoying.
Yes, definitely.
Alright, I guess I'll do it later then. She'll get a POG later in the week. She'll use the normal gun beige POG for now.
Okay.
Better be okay.
It is.
God damn it. Anyway. Alright, so we currently have... Damn it! That's the wrong button.
Also, sounds like I got an error that said you wanted this in the result of this roll. The turn tracker, but no valid token was selected, so.
Yeah, don't worry about that.
Okay.
When you're rolling for initiative in the future, though, you can select your.
Just like select it on the thing.
Okay. And then roll, and it'll automatically add it to my order thingy.
Okay. Yeah. I didn't know that's how it worked.
I always forget.
I didn't know
we were. I presumed it was like a character sheet thing that wasn't selected.
No, it's selecting the POG. Like,
okay.
Pete, while you were gone, I got a gem of ease lifted rank 25 and put it on a weapon for a barbarian.
So you get that barb coming along soon?
He's already like 52. So I've just been going in like Torment 6.
What are you guys talking about?
Diablo.
They're talking about Diablo. Right?
It's like all he and I fucking play.
Are we waiting for something?
Yep, just wanted to do that.
Okay.
Oh, damn, that deleted him. That's annoying.
Pete, you're not on Steam.
Alright, so I'll just remember he goes before the mob, but after you guys.
Okay.
Alright, a 10 cat.
Sorry, go ahead.
You are currently on a collapsed stage. There are six people crowding around the six prone people who had been crowding around the now lifeless body of the student protest leader. There is a collapsed wall of ice surrounding you, as well as a still intact river of wind that is keeping the crowd at bay. There are a number of crowd members that had already gone up on the stage that are currently getting up back off their feet. There is a gendarme lieutenant who is currently standing next to you, having kept her balance, as well as Silva, who is next to you as well, also having kept his balance.
Okay.
Odell has just leapt through a window behind you.
Yes.
He's dead.
So here's what I'm going to do. I am going to activate my Ring of Chameleon Power to use Disguise Self on me. And I will use it to make myself appear 2 feet taller and much, much more scary looking, both muscular and in facial features.
Do you have intimidate?
Yes.
Nice.
Okay.
I look like I'm rabid. My eyes are red and glowing. And My hands have turned into wicked claws.
I'm still thinking, how do people find this guy hot?
Some people are into that.
It's that sweet dog dick, bro.
I knew it.
Well, Red anyway. Rocket.
What else would it be?
And
also Tombstone? Gross.
So, does that net me any bonuses on Intimidate?
Roll Disguise.
Well, it's a spell, so it's not really affecting the ability to disguise.
Because if I'm not mistaken...
Disguise stuff doesn't do anything for... If you use a spell to create disguise, you gain plus 10 bonus on disguise check.
Yeah, still make
sure. Interacts with the glamour, gets a will save to recognize it as an illusion. So I'm not disguising myself to look like a different person, but I'm just trying to look scarier.
Yeah, but that. Still, it counts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Still follows the rules.
I understand. Ha! Fucking old one.
Nice.
Alright,
You look like a puppy.
Yeah, well, no.
Everyone in the crowd is more attracted to you.
You sort of do that, but being, a novice when it comes to disguising yourself, you just sort of make some very... It looked a lot grander in your head than what it actually turns out to be.
Oh, all right, man.
Well, that could not fucking intimidate them.
Should have had Urob there.
You can go right ahead and intimidate them, though.
Can I make a combat maneuver and intimidate?
Urob's try to grapple somebody near me.
Intimidate is a standard action, I think, if you're trying to scare people. Right.
Yep.
Well, then I will scare people.
Urob's probably the best cosplayer in the group.
Okay, yeah, you scare everybody on the stage and a bunch of people who aren't on the stage.
I am scared.
Oh. The people, as they're getting back up, stop it, are clearly taken aback by you.
I pull out my double axe and look like I'm ready to pounce at the first person who fucks with me.
Okay. Silva, is your turn.
Okay. How many people are still in front of us?
There's about 12 people on the stage, and there's a countless number of people in the crammed into the street before you. It's quite a wide avenue.
Okay. Are those people in front of us? And it's a 15-foot cone?
The 12?
Yeah. Could I fit them in a 15-foot cone in front of me? How many could I fit?
Like 4.
Okay. Well, I'll fit those 4 and cast Color Spray.
All right. They are now color sprayed.
If they have 2 hit die or less, they fail the fortitude save, they're knocked unconscious, blinded, and stunned for 2d4 rounds.
All right, they are unconscious, stunned, and blinded.
Sorry, guys.
Roll the amount of rounds.
Well, let's see here.
I pull up my beanbag shotgun.
Wow. 4
you
rounds.
Kill somebody with the trauma.
That's kind of what I'm worried that Silva's doing.
I'm just non-lethally taking them out.
It's got non-lethal in the name.
Yeah.
And then Crozy Mazin's going to cast Sleep in the middle of the big group.
I remember how in Shadowrun we were supposed to do a mission non-lethally, and then I killed someone with a car.
By the way, yes. By the way, Crozumazin, as he's preparing to do that, it occurs to him that doing this might cause problems if the crowd ever stampedes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's going to kill, 20-odd people.
Then he doesn't do that. What else can he do? Wait. Can I use silent image to make a really scary dragon monster?
Yes. Well, it won't make any sound, so it'll just sort of sit there. People will probably be really confused and then angry.
Oh, yeah. Hmm.
Well, he doesn't have to do, something crazy off the wall.
Crozy Mazin uses Mage Hand to pick up a little rock and throws it at someone.
What a dick.
Okay.
The master plan.
Odell, it is currently your turn. You are currently standing in a in-room. The door is ajar.
All right, I'm going to run over to that door and take a peek outside.
All right. You see a number of people in the inn's main chamber. Kind of like brushing themselves off of like various beer foods that were thrown on them by some disturbance, and a number of them looking at the rear door of the inn, which is currently open as well.
I'm going to dimension door over to the door.
All right. You are currently standing in an alley behind the inn. A number of people rush past you going towards the main street, while you... you do not see Red, but you do see a cast off great coat and hat.
All right. The people that are running towards the street is
none of them have red hair.
Gonna do a quick detect magic. Red was a barbarian or something like that, right? He was a fighter. He
didn't have any disguises.
Sorry.
Hats of disguises, like he could have a hat of disguise. So, like, do a detect magic, I would say.
Yeah.
But you actually have no idea what Red was.
No. Okay. But yeah, I'll still do a detect magic right around here.
Except that he worshipped Fervus. That's what you knew.
Fervus.
Okay. That was the god of chaos.
Or had a relationship with him, or something. Just chill with him.
Very intimate relationship.
Into Fervus and chill.
Fucking idiot.
They'd hang out at each other's houses, watch movies.
Have sex.
Well, okay, the guys that just ran past you, they did not have any magic on them. However, the guy that just ran around the corner down the block... does. Like, quite a bit.
Alright. I will... Can I still do a dimension door over to him?
You are a dimension door this turn.
Yes. Well, I mean, I also detected magic this turn, so...
Yes.
No, dimension door is a move action. That's why it's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then I shall cast it as a swift action and charge at him. Oh, wait, no? Huh? I'll spend a... Do I have that as my mythic feats?
Well, detect magic is a standard.
Just give me a second here. I don't remember where I put my mythic stuff because I didn't put it in my feats page.
Hey, Sal, so what would you say the hit die of the people in the crowd are?
All right, I will arcane
surge. Probably very, very low, I imagine.
Kill all the people.
I will arcane surge and dimension door as a swift action over to him.
All right. You are currently right next to him because he's pretty much just rounded the corner.
All right. He doesn't look the same at all now.
I'm sorry? Right,
Can I try to grab a hold of him?
No.
No.
Okay.
You have used up literally every action you have.
So you
could say, halt, citizen, with your free.
You have crammed a lot of stuff into this one turn.
Yep.
I like how you're trying to get more, though. I like the gumption.
You could, you have free actions left.
Seriously, halt, citizen.
Yeah, like, I'll just say, like, red?
That's got no weight. As opposed to halt citizen.
It doesn't, but I mean, like, if it is red,
the man.
If not, then I'll just pursue him later.
The man whirls around towards you, and yeah, that's red. He looks different.
He's blue now.
He's got a big scar.
He's got the same green eyes. Got the same red hair. He's got the same freckles.
Maybe he's super obsessed with causing chaos, and now he is a beast on Ross. Maybe that's what's been happening to everyone.
But he's different in other ways. He has a lean and hungry look to him now. Yeah. Rather deep shadows under his eyes, as if he hasn't slept. And the smile he gives you isn't entirely benign. But it is one of recognition. And not necessarily, and non-aggressiveness. So you're not very, so you're a little surprised when he just sort of waves at you. Goes, hi, Odell.
Oh.
And then, yeah, I'd be surprised too.
And then lets a little bead slip out of his hand, which bursts into smoke on the ground.
Damn.
hell no.
He's a ninja.
Emiria, it's now your turn.
I tell people to stop pushing me around. Does that work?
They don't seem to be listening to you. They are calling you nasty words like beak and other raptor slurs.
That is.
And other misogynistic slurs as well.
That is very, very not cool. Is that thing I got from the air dragon supernatural?
Yes, it is.
I do that. So I beat my wings back and forth, and there's a cyclone in a 30-foot radius around me. And medium or smaller creatures in the area make a reflex check to be pushed back.
You can potentially, you will be doing damage with this.
I will be doing damage, but this is my out.
Oh, wow. It's only non-lethal.
Good. Yeah.
Okay. If it was large, it's funny. It's actually more damaging to large creatures. But, okay, yeah. You knock everybody within 30 feet of you onto the ground and push them back into the rest of the crowd, which panics and sort of surges away from you. That's full round?
Is that full round? I don't know. It doesn't say on my thing.
I'm going to go ahead and say that it is, because that seems like something you have to sort of build up for the course of 6 seconds.
I quick rider shirt and fly up 50 feet in the air.
Okay, you can do that.
I do that.
You are currently 50 feet up in the air.
Thank you, John, for that picture.
Actually, you probably should have done that first, because you need to be hovering before you do the cyclone.
Well, I figured I probably couldn't get up in the air if I was being jostled.
Oh, well. After Miria goes first, the lieutenant will go...
This is quickly growing out of control.
You will leave crowd control to the authorities, she says, not entirely convinced of what she's saying herself.
I shrug.
Or you will continue... No, I am deputizing you immediately in the name of the Imperial Gendarmerie. You will hold back this crowd here, and I will continue to chase after the man who shot this man.
Do I get a badge?
No.
Darn.
She turns around and rushes into the building behind you.
He deserves a badge. He's a poor little robot. He doesn't know any better.
John, this link's for you.
It's me.
Yep.
I like how it's credited as a photo.
Love that picture.
It's pretty fucking good, gotta say.
Anyway. Around you, however, you note that a number of teleportation spells are going off.
Oh.
As more gendarmes, about 10 or so, are appearing on various rooftops. Or a couple closer to the stage. They begin ordering the crowd to disperse and demanding that those who have raised arms against the agents of the Empire lay down and prepare to be taken into custody. The crowd does not seem willing to comply, however, and begins surging in multiple directions as people start joining it from off the street. One gendarme who was on the street manages to fire, does fire his weapon, not casting a spell, which appears to be foolish on his part, as he shoots one person who collapses, and then the crowd just sets upon him immediately, and he's just dragged down and disappears beneath it.
Damn.
His screaming stops very rapidly. This has set the other gendarmes to just start firing various rays into the crowd. A couple of them are firing waves of fatigue into them. But the situation in general is rapidly deteriorating. Also, one gendarme orders you, Emiria, to come down and prepare to be processed.
Flying as against the law.
You have rights. You have
knocking
rights.
Down like 100 or so people with a giant cyclone is against the law. Attent Ket, is currently your turn. There are currently 12 very intimidated people in front of you. Four of whom are unconscious.
Okay.
I give him a thumbs up.
I'm going to grapple the nearest one. I'm going to reach out with a meaty fist.
All right, you grapple him.
And I look at the others, and I tell them to leave now.
We can't leave. There's a windy thing behind us. It'll knock us down.
Go in the wind.
Okay. they go in the wind. They're all knocked down and unconscious.
This is my river of wind.
Everyone immediately dies.
Isn't my river of wind still going during all this as well?
Yes, it's the one thing keeping like 100 or so people just swarming over you and like beating you to death.
Nice.
Oh, funny, they're not gonna beat me to death. I'll fuck them up.
Beat them off to death, more like.
I'm fucking ripped, man. Also, my god, John, is that Thunder Fury? Bless the way of the Windseeker?
We're not doing this.
Silva, is now your turn.
Okay. What aren't we doing? Let's see here. I'm going to expend Mythic Point and cast Char Monster Mass on as many people as I can. Which is 30 hit die worth.
Okay, you charm 30 people.
Nice. I tell them to calm down.
Just calm down.
30 people just sort of just calm down.
Nice. Mission accomplished.
They're wondering what's going they're all telling you that we're calm now, but like there's a whole bunch of people that these people were hostile towards you, Silva. They're only moved up into neutral. You tell them to calm down and they're just like, "No, why?"
I shrug.
We want to fucking kill those guys.
Come on, man. Don't be a dick.
Conflict will just lead on to conflict.
You can make a diplomacy check.
Someone's diplomacy is awful. Let me try, though.
Oh, yeah, you have the whole Iteron penalty to diplomacy because you're a robot.
Yeah.
Stop being so illogical.
It makes them even more violent.
1010, this means peace in my language.
Yeah, I'm afraid that doesn't quite work, Silva. However, on the bright side, you got 30 people who aren't trying to kill you.
Yes. Success.
Odell.
Yes.
The screws of Rhea, I don't know.
I'm assuming in the smoke bomb that I've lost track of him, or...
Well, you're currently in a smoke bomb. You can't really see where he's going, but you can hear him... running away from you.
Alright, I will spend an arcana to smell him, to see which direction he's going.
He doesn't smell.
He took a shower.
That's a magical scent, right?
Yes.
Right, so it only senses mages?
If they have a ability to cast spells.
He doesn't smell.
Alright, can I... What I want to do... is I'm going to use Dimensional Dervish to charge using Dimension Door towards him. Can I detect the direction he's going enough to do that? Or would I just...
Make a perception check? Yeah, you sort of, you're losing track of him, like, really fast.
Alright, I'm just gonna...
You could just try it. You'll have a pretty big miss chance.
Yep, I'm just gonna try and do that.
Okay, go ahead.
What do you want me to roll?
Your attack roll.
Okay. This would have been non-lethal, so there's another minus four on that.
Alright, you're only making the single attack because of...
Yeah.
Right.
I just have it set up to roll a bunch.
Mm-hmm. Alright. You whop through the... first off, roll 1d2. Ah.
Nice.
Alright, well, that just really changes the description. You whop through the smoke and actually are about to land a blow into Red when he just sort of whirls around drawing a star knife and deflects it off to the side, skidding back as he does so away from you.
Okay, and now I am going to spend another...
He raises an eyebrow at you and sort of grins crookedly.
I will spend another...
I'm not done my cool shit yet.
Another mythic point to hydraulic push him. So I'm going to add my caster level to this as well to make a CMB check to try and... Oh, okay.
He does a flip over it. The crooked smile and raised eyebrows just sort of switched to a really sort of expression.
Squirtle, use water gun.
I guess I'll just sulk a bit then.
Okay.
It's like, I guess in the time I'll ask him, like, what are you doing, Red? What's the meaning of all this?
You know, stuff.
This guy.
I just do things. It's what I do. Hey, look over there. And he runs down the side corridor alley that he was standing next to.
You do things. No way. I do things, too. Stab.
Emiria, it's currently your turn.
Well, now I feel dumb. I really don't know what time I should be doing here.
There's still a gendarme shouting at you.
There is a gendarme shouting at me. Where is the gendarme? Like, at the stage?
No, he's actually on one of the rooftops on the other side of the avenue. He's waving towards...
Because well, shit, that's a lot of social pressure. I sheepishly go land beside him.
Oh, that you did. Of course you did. I'm a gendarme of the Empire. You will stay right here.
Do you want any help with the...
No! Dimension doors away down to the... down to the street.
Well, okay then.
So you're currently just sort of standing there on the roof.
What now?
It occurs to you that probably meant to like put manacles on you, but he forgot. Possibly due to just having a parking
lot. Yeah, that's a shit going on. I understand.
You can come get me later. I'll be here. No worries.
Are you going to just stay there?
For now, yes.
All right. The guy that I just waved to you, Emiria, teleports down to the ground, begins ordering people to lie down on the ground and surrender. When one rushes him, he fires a thin green beam out of his gun that immediately disintegrates the person.
This will end well.
A brick then hits him in the side of the head. He stumbles, and the crowd is upon him in an instant.
Well.
So, notice that the gendarmes are starting to teleport away now.
I cast fly and get the fuck out of there.
It may be prudent to do on your turn.
Yeah.
The crowd is continuing to grow and is beginning to start, like, rioting. Well, it's already a riot. It's becoming a growing riot and is beginning to surge down both sides of the avenue. One avenue, you note, or one direction on the avenue, you note, happens to lead back towards the arena, which isn't particularly far away at this point. Aristus and Urab!
Hello!
Hello!
It is I, the Fishman.
How's the fight going?
Congratulations, Aristus. You just won 166 gold as the Gilman Retiarius has jammed a trident into the big, burly Minotaur's throat.
After the match,
big deal. I can
Duma
do that.
Duma Dinanthan plays.
I can do that.
Whoa, usually. That's a big
one
dog.
Eye open. I just want to know that what he's doing. Whoa, that's a big dog. I can't sing.
Nope. Moving on.
Okay.
Thank you, Fruit.
I figured you probably based it off of the Canadian Empire, right?
Surely. I'm so glad that someone made the connection.
The famous slave empire, Canada.
Yes, yes. I can confirm.
Anyway. As you're sitting there, getting ready for the next match, and Prince Polonius is sort of just... He has gone back into fat idiot mode and just sort of describing the various day-to-day experiences of the match while... cramming greater and greater amounts of food into himself.
Ew.
But he's eating.
I don't need to imagine that.
Too bad. Now that will be the last thing you think about before you go to sleep at this time tonight.
Well, shit.
It usually is.
That's what I imagine the sounds are.
No, he's not grunting as he's doing it. He's actually, he's actually very, very polite and proper as he's just
guzzling
and cleanly as he's guzzles himself. He hasn't gotten any on his clothing, which is impressive considering that he's reclining and has a rather expansive amount of clothing.
Well, I'm gonna go out on a limb and guess he's had a lot of practice.
There are two things I'm very good at. Intrigue and eating. And I prefer to do the eating. Only one of... Both of them are hobbies. Only one of them is a passion.
Wait.
It is eating.
Surprise.
In case that was unclear. A guard has just rushed into the room. And has ordered the various guards and slaves to get the prince out of here immediately. There's a riot less than a mile away from here, heading this way.
Oh my god, did somebody throw a folding chair?
What? Ignore him. He's a little eccentric. He's fine, though. He's amusing to me. He says, patting Aristus on the head. Nice. Now, excuse me, but what is the nature of this threat? It's a riot, my prince. The people are...
Rioting.
Rioting! The peasants are revolting! You said it. Stick on ice.
In case somebody didn't know what the hell I was talking about.
I know, it was a Boondocks reference.
God damn it.
It just sucked.
I know.
Kidding.
So,
I'm not.
I assume that my slaves are to bear me back to the palace?
All no, the my slaves prince. Have rioted.
No, my prince, that is too dangerous. We'd have to go directly through the riot to get you out of here, and I fear you would not survive the experience.
Oh. We windwalked.
The wind can't hold him.
Can your windwalk carry that much?
Technically, I'll look it up.
I don't think it's a weight limit, honestly.
Well, I know like, that it's many, like a people limit. I'm
how, many people, had, how many people does he count as?
They had to invent a completely new unit of measurement.
I mean, it's just a one-touched creature. It doesn't say anything about weight.
How many max? How many people's creatures can you take max?
Per three levels, so I can carry five.
He counts as six.
People. Yeah, I don't know how much he weighs, but.
No, that's fine. He only counts as one. It's magic, you know.
Yeah.
I ain't gotta explain shit.
But as for his household. Oh, I'm sure they'll be fine.
Why don't you just kill them?
What? Why would I do that? Do you know how expensive slaves are? It's much better to keep them healthy.
Well, yeah, but they're revolting. You want to set an example so they don't do it in future.
Oh. Actually, the slaves are. This is not a slave revolt. These are freemen.
Oh, that's what I'm saying. Kill the freemen.
What a bunch of douchebags.
Kill free man.
See, this is why everybody needs to be enslaved.
Oh, don't worry. I'm sure someone will do that for us. But in the meantime, I do think it might be wise to evacuate the current environs.
When you said, I'm sure someone will do that for us, I thought, sounds like a job for the champions of Ardania.
Meanwhile, the champions begin their slaughter.
Zombie, do lead the servants out into one of my... I know. Hide them in
the
vomitorium.
The what?
No one will look there.
Oh, God.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
It's the vomitorium. We've gone over this every time he mentions it.
Although he himself does not use the vomitorium because he cannot fit into it.
I apologize, just to be clear, every time I hear...
When we say vomitorium, we mean like the... Not like... The doorway into amphitheaters. We mean like a room for vomiting.
Yes.
No, I know. That's why every
time. No. I'm clarifying for myself because technically, well, you know, whatever.
Yes. Yes. Everybody actually gets that confused, but I'm not actually using Latin. I'm using fun Latin.
Right.
What the fuck?
Anyway. Where was I? Yes. So, Zombie will lead my, my people out into a safe place. If you could take myself and Aristus and those four over there, he says, gesturing to the burly Minotaur slaves. I'd be very much obliged.
That's six. Aristus, you're gonna have to stay.
Oi! Whatever, I pull out my trident. Pull out my gun!
Aristus, pretend to be a freeman and join the riot.
No, this is a good chance for me to become show
the,
off.
Become the people's champion.
Aristus, you're a criminal. Hey, like, join the riot and infiltrate their ranks and use your great diplomacy.
Yeah, become their champion.
Use that thing you're known for, diplomacy.
He actually has a really good diplomacy.
Yeah, I'm actually a really good talker.
Well,
tell them to lay down their arms.
I is a good talker.
you know what? I'm going to try to calm the riots. That or I get a chance to kill everybody and show off how good I am with a trident. Better than that champion. Oh my god. Like, did you see how he swung his trident?
Okay, Urab away!
All right, Urab, you cast Windwalk, and you and Prince Polonius and the four Minotaurs go flying towards the palace.
All right, time to go.
You get a bird's eye view of a massively growing riot. Prince Polonius's lounge chair has somehow Windwalked with him.
All right.
It's actually just a carapace.
I proceed to throw my trident.
Where are you?
What?
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 What are you doing?
Never mind.
Okay, good. I won't.
Not a part of the riot. Look, he just threw a trident.
I was throwing a trident into the riot.
All right, the riot is not quite outside yet. You can start to hear the sound of people yelling. Well, actually, no, that's just sort of the arena.
What's the best possible... Like, is there a... When we were watching the match, was there, like, a fucking guy screaming over the match, I guess?
Urab's not right there right now, but the spirit of Urab is. And he's saying, you're not going to calm down the riots.
Okay, I'm going to go hide.
Try.
There was actually an announcer.
Yeah, I would use the thing...
He's dead.
But no, he was magically
murdered.
Made louder. He was using a thing.
Shit, we don't have loud.
No, you do not have megaphones.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of.
Loudspeakers.
Yeah. Shit, I guess I should go hide. I activate my stealth.
You start hiding.
My stealth card.
All right, Zombie is currently leading the
A zombie's leading?
No, not a zombie. A zombie. The Prince Polonius' head servant.
Hmm. Oh, am I supposed to say something?
Yes.
What was zombie?
Alright. I was gonna hide, but...
Alright, roll stealth.
Alright, that's my stealth. My stealth is... Again,
20 plus 17. Okay, you are stealthed. You are sort of just hiding amongst the columns that surround this large chamber in the Colosseum.
I can't pull like an Assassin's Creed and meld in with the crowd.
You didn't.
The crowd is actually being kept in their seats by the guards to prevent them from leaving and joining the massive riot.
All right. Well, I guess I'll just do what you said.
Alright.
Also, I don't have a hood.
Yes, that is also true. Atenket.
The universal distress. Yes.
What do you do? You are currently on a stage surrounded by a wind wall.
And holding a person.
And holding a person. Who is looking at you nervously.
I put him down.
He sort of looks around shiftily.
I brush some of the dust off his shoulders. And then I roar at him.
He jumps into the wind wall and is knocked out.
Turn over.
Very good. Silva, what do you do?
Let's see.
You said you were casting Fly?
I might cast something else. Hey, Atenket, do you need to be out of here immediately?
Nah, I could probably take him.
Okay, I cast Phantom Steed.
What does Phantom Steed do again?
It summons a Phantom Horse, which right now has a fly speed of 100 for me, so...
Oh, alright.
Yeah, I summon that, and I just fucking, like, jettison off.
Alright, you're out of here.
I go in the direction Odell was going, see if I can catch up to him. Hopefully I can manage to make some distance with 100 feet for 6 seconds.
Yes. Well, you only get to make a move action, so you're not moving for the entire 6 seconds because you cast the spell first.
Okay.
So you do manage to go 100 feet in Odell's general direction. Make a perception check.
Okay, let's see here. perception.
You actually see Odell and another guy.
Huh. I presume that's all I can do for my turn, so.
Yes.
I keep my eye on him.
Odell, Red is currently looking at you really unimpressed.
All right.
Odell, you really don't want to do this.
Red, I need some answers here. But what's going on? Why did you just shoot that man?
The Dumadin Empire is a disease.
Oh, my God, man, this is like such a beast that rides, man.
Why would he shoot a guy who's going against the Dumadin Empire?
Then? I was not really joking with my
no
hilariously flippant remark.
Yes.
It's been systematically destroying freedom for the last 400 years across this entire continent. It needs to be expunged. And sometimes the only way you can begin to expunge a wound is through fire.
The best way to tell if a guy is a Beast That Rides guy is when they use language that's vaguely sexual and uncomfortable.
But didn't say that was sexual.
I don't know, word choice like expunge.
Oh.
How close am I to him? Like, am I within melee range of him?
You are in melee. Are within melee range of him, yes, essentially.
Alright, then I am just going to spell combat him.
Spell combat!
I can't really do non-lethal damage with spells, I believe.
Ha ha! Meatballs, how droll!
What? I'm gonna cast some black tentacles on him. Well, just full round attack him.
You can cast black tentacles?
I have black tentacles as well, I just have not used it.
Alright, roll the grapple check and then roll your attacks.
Oh, very Japanese.
Also, roll the grapple check against yourself. Unless you're just catching him with
the edge. Yeah, every time you use black tentacles, you have to make that sound.
No, you don't. I'm pretty sure the black tentacles don't discriminate.
That's the best part.
Yeah, it's every creature.
Yeah.
Yep.
Alright, so are you just catching him with the edge of it, or are you just sort of dropping it on yourself?
I'll put it kind of like on the other side of him, so if he keeps trying to run away from me, he has to go through the tentacles.
Okay.
And is my, and I'm buffing my sword at the same time.
Okay.
For usual.
Roll the combat maneuver bonus for the tentacles, as well as...
Oh.
Your attacks. Well.
Well, you...
There's minus four on all the attacks as well. To...
you fail right, even so harder.
I guess that was the base attack bonus, since you have a plus four. There's a plus four bonus on strength for them here, and a plus one for their size, so plus five total. Oh, that's only one attack.
Yes, it is.
That's not right. Ignore the first attack on this roll.
Okay. The, all right. Red slashes through the tentacles that are trying to grab him, dodging through the rest, while also deflecting your blows with his star knives, of which he has drawn a second one from somewhere. He's no longer smiling. Odell, you really don't want to mess with me right now.
Oh my god, what a whiner. Oh, you don't really mess with me right now.
It's actually more of a warning.
Ben? I can't let you do this. I can't let you just kill random people.
Well, I already have, so you could just let me go.
That's not happening.
I already did it. Just let me go. This guy's a fucking...
Come along peacefully, Red, and this can all be dealt with.
Yeah, you know what the Empire would do to me?
I'll see what I can do to protect
you. Make you fight in gladiatorial games and kill you eventually?
Yes, Voice of Rob, that's exactly what would happen.
You're welcome.
Yeah, you can't. So, you have a choice. You could continue trying to stop me, at which point I will eventually just get frustrated with you and stop you from trying to stop me. Or you could stop casting these really, like, mildly annoying spells at me and just let me jump through that sewer grate over there.
Oh, how convenient.
And I'll meet with you some other time. It'll be great. We'll share stories.
Are you in this on your own? Do you have other people working with you?
You see all those people over there?
I look over.
Towards the mob that is starting to flood into the alleys, which is actually not good for you. I'm working with those people.
Oh, barf. Put your poetry somewhere else.
That's who he reminds me of.
Voice of Urab. Just through this mist of time.
Rob's trying to hang up the phone.
How did you even
stupid
get...
Stupid time phone.
Boat.
And you came up with this all on your own?
I'm not exactly inexperienced with, like, social disorder.
You should ask him why he killed someone who was going against the Empire.
He shrugs at you.
This just seems a pretty big change from when I saw you last. Well, not a big change, but...
Yeah, well, different situations require different remedies. Ardania needed freedom. Doom and the Empire needs destruction.
So he's giving more power to the Empire by killing any dissenters?
Missing the big picture here, Silva.
Oh yeah, he was dressed up as a guy.
Chaos, bro.
Yeah.
Fruit, will you stop? I know it's you!
You're a cook with the lid.
Man, I have been missing out on some solid fucking gold, apparently.
Don't get upset, you have some spaghetti.
I'm sorry, that is actually really funny, though.
They're all, like, top-notch. 10 out of 10.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry, Red, but
it's not
this is too radical for me. I can't let you get away with this.
That's going to be a problem. Okay, Odell, but don't worry, but just remember, you asked for this. He throws away the two star knives, and in his hands suddenly erupt a pair of new star knives made from roiling chaotic energy. And he starts laying into you with them.
Alright, I'm going to pop an Arcana to give myself plus 5 AC.
Oh no, you're dead.
AC is 33.
You still have Urab's emergency bring you back to life thing, right?
Ah, you're dead.
Didn't he use it when he got blown up that one time?
No. I mean, I would assume that I would have
Yes, I guess.
Yeah. Yes, he would.
Wow, he critted a lot on that.
Damn. He really did.
Like, and his damage kind of spiked. I wasn't expecting him to round you like that.
Well, he did say Odell asked for this.
Yep. 91.
Can't believe Odell fucking died.
All right. Odell, add up numbers until you're dead. He stops after you fall down.
18. Well, and as soon as you're dead, the contingency will kick in. Well, as soon as you're negative.
Yes.
17. I'll be at minus 17 after attack number 5.
Okay, so then roll 4d8 plus 15. Well, I guess I should do that because I'm the cleric. There you go.
All right, you recover 31 health, putting you at.
What do you say? We're minus
16.
Minus 17.
Then attack 6, okay. Then you're dead.
No, then it's gonna be 14.
Yeah, you're now at negative 14, which I believe plus does 14. Not kill you.
Plus 14. And then the the last 25 hitting.
You are at negative 15 after attack 5, right?
Negative 17.
Oh, you're on negative.
Oh no, I have DR 3 on each of those attacks.
Oh.
I know. That's
okay, end result is that you're prone and unconscious but alive, and you're automatically stabilized.
29.
Okay. Well, then you're still prone from when you got knocked the fuck out, but the spell brought you back to life, and then the last attack brought you down to 6.
Mm. Okay. Oh, but yes.
All right, well, Red no longer has a turn because he just full round attacked you.
Nice.
Emiria.
Well, looks like things went to shit.
Don't worry, I'm on this.
What?
Put the.
Where are you and what were you doing? What are you doing?
I'm fighting Red.
It's not. I'm nowhere near that. Is Silva still here, right?
No, I went there and I flew over and I'm almost over to him now. I can see him. So I just saw Odell get the ship beat of him. So next turn I'm gonna fly down there with my phantom horse, and like
we're level
probably
2 mythic, right?
Huh?
And that means we've only got 2 mythic points, right?
I have 7 mythic points.
No, you have 7.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Where's this riot going?
I want in.
All directions. But primarily down the main avenue that started on.
One of those organized riots.
Simply because it has the most room to expand. People who aren't joining the riot are like rapidly turning carts around and trying to get them away.
Oh, things must have been really tense here.
I open, I quickly flip a pitchfork cart. I'm like, here, get your pitchforks here.
And
pitchforks.
You imagine doing this, but you're currently flying with Prince Polonius.
Damn it.
Torches and pitchforks.
Low, low price. Get your torches and pitchforks.
So, Silva, like, are you in the air right now?
Yeah.
Silva is riding a spectral horse.
Yeah.
Okay, that's pretty hard to miss. I'm going to follow him.
Yeah, and it flies at 100 like feet per second or whatever. Well, it's a fly speed of 100 feet.
100 feet per second, huh? Per second.
That is way too fast. Yeah.
It's 100 foot per, like, move
it
speed.
It goes at the speed of light.
Yeah. Almost.
100 feet per second, also known as the speed of light.
Yeah, that's about as fast as light goes.
I've seen light poking.
Yeah. I ran fast.
I'm just going to go follow Sylvan.
Okay. What's your fly speed?
My fly speed is 50.
Nice. But you also probably just spent your whole turn catching up, so.
Well, I would be doing...
She'll grab the tail and then, like, skateboard behind it.
I do that.
All right, fine. You know what? I don't care. All right, you catch up to Silva, and you're currently being dragged along by a spectral horse. Attend Ket.
Yes.
There is a riot going on in front of you. It is rapidly turning ugly. A number of people have been killed already. Also, Silva abandoned you on a collapsed stage.
Yeah, I asked him if he's okay with it, and he said he was, so.
What about the gendarme lady?
She rushed through the. She rushed into the inn and through the. To try and chase after Red.
Well then, it looks like the only one who can stop this riot is me.
Does he crack his knuckles?
You can't stop a riot.
I prepare a full round attack now.
against the riot.
You should have put your sunglasses on and started chewing bubblegum and pulled out your shotgun.
I cleave so much, Swain.
Yeah, I know how to stop this riot with violence.
Isn't that how riots are usually solved?
I'm going to go... Fire hose? Is anybody coming at me?
No. There are the six guys who are currently trying to tend to their friend who was shot. And everybody else that tried to get up on the stage are currently either knocked unconscious or are knocked unconscious.
Mm-hmm.
There were two other gendarmes that teleported onto the stage when the riot began, but they've since teleported away when the gendarmes started getting killed.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So, all right. I go and appraise the man on the ground who has been shot.
Roll a heal check. Oh, very good. He is actually alive, which none of his friends seem to have been able to tell. They're just sort of standing there weeping over him. But if he doesn't have medical attention very rapidly, he will exsanguinate.
Shout at the top of my lungs via an intimidate check, stating that he's alive, but he needs help.
Okay, I would like you to deliver the angriest, like...
That's very angry.
Yeah, wow. Okay, they're freaking intimidated. They sort of go... after they're done, like, trying to control their bodily functions, they go... How are we
get potions now.
Medicraft!
Get potions now!
We don't... Where are we supposed to get potions from?
Is there an apothecary nearby?
Well, it's a riot. They probably already flipped that place.
Yeah, one of them just gestures at the giant riot. You notice a store named Bob's Potions that's now been lit on fire.
Al's chemical emporium has been set on fire.
It explodes.
Okay. Let's see. I might be able to signal the Urub signal. I am going to perception. Do I see anything of use?
Cloud moving fast?
You see a really fat cloud.
Yes, you see yourself. It occurs to you if you roll a second roll like that, you could stop the bleeding.
I attempt to stop.
Sorry. It's like the power was within you all along.
You just have to get angry enough. Another roll just like that.
Yeah, you got a roll exactly like that, in fact. You were able to, with pressure and, well, I guess just a lot of pressure, you scare the blood back into him.
Okay,
Now he has a severe bruise from where you were laying into him with your knee, but otherwise he stopped bleeding.
I also fashioned a makeshift tourniquet, blah, blah, blah.
Well, you'd be tourniqueting his torso. I don't know how you're really going to do that.
Well, I bandage it.
Okay.
And I tell one of them to keep pressure on the wound, and I pick him up, and I tell the others to help me work my way through the crowd.
I think that crowd is going to try and kill us. Also, if we go through that wind wall thing, we're all going to get knocked unconscious like those guys.
Okay, I go through the building that the gendarme went through.
Okay.
That's what I mean. Like, you know,
you're currently in an inn. Actually, one of the inn's rooms. One of them suggests, couldn't we just lay him down here?
What if the riot decides, let's burn down this entire city block?
Well, you're a big guy. You could carry him out if that happens.
Fine. Go find somebody who works there and see if they have any emergency medical potions.
Will do, dog man.
Tell them that we can pay.
Why do we care about this guy? Let him die.
A 10K is a good person.
Because it's the right thing to do, you shit brick.
What alignment okay. are you?
Come down here and heal him.
Nah, man.
Oh, actually, a 10K. It occurs to you that Castellarius has just sort of been standing there.
Wait, Castellarius, get Urob right now.
How do you expect me to get Urob?
Think about it real hard.
Ask Gatum Tempora, Castellarius.
Can you heal things?
No.
He can't, no.
Oh, wait, can Castellarius just reverse the time on his wound?
Can you...
on his wound?
Look, you can fly, right?
Yes, I can.
Then go find Urob and bring him back here.
I could just fly him to a hospital or something.
What if they burn down the hospital in the riot?
Whatever, sure. Fine. Can you take me too?
Hey, no riot is that.
He just picks him up, takes him around a corner, snaps his neck, and then shows back up. All right, I flew him to the hospital.
Can Castellarius split himself into two and take both the injured guy and a 10-cat?
Actually, yes. Yeah, Castellarius transforms back into his normal Mysticos-looking self. And multi-manifests.
Cool. I tell the guys that won't... the people that I, you know, am with, that won't be necessary. See you later.
Alright, thank you for saving our friend. Alright, well, he rolled the minimum, so there's just two of them.
Yeah.
One grabs the guy, and they start flying towards the nearest hospital, which it occurs to him that he has no idea where it is.
So he peers into is Urob.
So he peers into the future to see where he takes this guy, and immediately starts flying in the direction of the palace.
Fucking bullshit.
He peers into the future to see where he takes this guy, and sees himself peering into the future, figuring out where to take this guy.
And then he looks back at himself and says, "This makes me uncomfortable." Spaceballs!
Are you kidding? This thing happens all the time to him. He's gotten used to it a long time ago.
A few moments later, a Tin Cat notices Castellarius say, "Oh, hey, Castellarius, you're gonna go this way." And then, yeah.
What?
Castellarius is talking to himself to tell him where to go.
Thanks, Castellarius. You're welcome, Castellarius. At 10-cat, you rapidly start getting confused.
I have a headache.
Silva, it is currently your turn.
Okay. I resume what I saw. Red kicked the shirt of Odell?
You did.
Okay. I basically just shoot down with my Phantom Seed right to the ground.
Okay. You're currently face-to-face with Red.
And also, I make sure I land on top of the manhole he was probably going to escape down.
You can die.
Not okay. On my watch. I expend a mythic point to cast Whole Person on him.
Yeah, oh no.
Go right ahead. You are not within his melee range, so I just have to sort of make it will save.
Yep, it's 25.
Mm-hmm. You cast your spell. What does Hold Person look like for you? I've seen a whole bunch of different things. Does he just sort of freeze in place? Does he get wrapped around by, like, spectral ribbons? Does...
let's go... Also, I meant to say Hold Monster.
A big red canceled symbol appears over.
A Flavor clock wraps around.
I like to think it's a spectral ribbons thing. That sounds cool. Right.
Spectral ribbons begin to wrap around his form. Before he sort of just spins through them and shakes his head of the spell.
Oh, so you actually shake it off?
Yes.
Okay. Well then.
And stabs you right through the gut parts.
I still have one other plan because I still have an action left.
Mm-hmm.
Instead, I cast Great Pit.
He gets a reflex save against that, right?
Yep.
Summon Brad Pitt.
What's the DC for that?
22.
I think the only way I could fail this is rolling a 1.
Probably.
Actually, I'm sure of that. I did not roll a 1.
Damn.
So, yeah, he just sort of leaps backwards away from the pit.
But does that mean Odell falls into the pit?
No.
Odell was directly adjacent to him.
Yeah.
I just make it so it's only like... I make it so it doesn't
catch Does Odell. Not catch it, Odell?
Yeah.
Is the pit sheer? Like, it's just straight down? It's not a gradual slope?
Yeah, it's just a straight drop.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
Odell, is now your turn. You're currently prone.
Wait, also, Crozy Mazin. Wait, let me just attempt something with Crozy Mazin. Just because.
So... he's still sitting beside me, eh?
Standing. But yeah. Prozimazin is actually going because I forgot
he... You forgot about him.
Okay.
Yeah. Well.
Let me see here. He's going to... Let's see. He's going to attempt to flare him. And that's a 42 save, which is just 13.
Flare?
Yep.
The thing that dazzles.
Yep.
Yeah, he doesn't fail his fortitude save.
Okay.
And he just sort of rolls his eyes at Crozy Mazin.
Well, Crozy Mazin just barks at him. I don't know. Okay. Now it's Odell's turn.
Yes.
All right.
Odell, you are severely uncomfortable.
Yes. I forget how to do DC for, like, reflex save. That's just, like, casting modifier plus spell level?
Yep. Plus 10.
Plus 10.
Why are you making a reflex save?
No, I'm not.
Oh, okay.
Well, I guess I'll try. From the prone position, I am going to do a spell combat.
Okay.
I am going to spend a mythic point. two mythic points. And I'm going to spend two arcana.
I wasn't sure if I should just outright try to kill this guy or try to capture him alive, so...
So, two mythic points, two arcana, and the whole breakdown is... In my spell combat, I'm attacking from prone, I'm hitting on touch AC... And I am going to cast mirror images on myself and a maximized fire snake on him. It's just kind of like I get so many feet of it, so I'm just going to kind of go around him a couple times and just go up so it doesn't hit anyone else.
Okay.
So he gets the save against that, which is 20. And then I will roll my attacks and I will roll my spell.
Yeah, he passed the reflex save.
So there would be a -8 on all both attacks, but they are hitting on touch AC.
Okay. -8 on those?
Yeah.
So the first one is actually a 23, second one is a 21, third one is a 22. And it's not an automatic hit because it's a 19 and not a 20.
Yeah.
So as a result, you actually miss the three times.
Okay.
However, you do startle Red enough to make him flip backwards. Away
into
from
the,
your...
Into the pit.
No, over the pit, actually.
Darn.
Away from your fire snake. He, at this point, has seen... is now looking at you, Silva, and Emiria arrayed against him. And with that, dispels the two energy star knives. And runs down the street beside him.
Isn't there a black tentacles there?
Yes. Odell, make your grapple check. He He dodges through them like a boss.
There's a plus 5 on that.
He dodges through them like a boss, but with slightly more difficulty. Emiria, is now your turn.
So, Red's running, right?
Yes.
How far... If I'm with Aristus, I mean Silva, how far is Red about?
The alley he ran down is about 20 feet away.
Oh, so he's really close. Could I round that corner and see where he is?
Absolutely.
Silva, didn't you try hold person on him?
Yeah, it didn't work. I tried hold monster on him specifically. It didn't work. Because hold monster has the higher DC.
Mm-hmm. Let me look up the range on this one. He's in close range, isn't he? Like, that's about 900.
Presumably. You cannot actually see him at this time, before you move.
I'm going to move first.
All right, move, make a perception check. He's gone!
What?
Turned into a bundle of sticks.
Yes, he turned into a bundle of sticks, thank you.
He was nowhere there in the first place.
As Odell can attest, he was in fact very much there.
No, the bundle of sticks did it.
So this is an alley, right?
Yes.
Is there anyone in the alley, Dicey?
No, the alley is empty.
I'm going to fill it with a cone of fire.
No, go ahead. God.
Why?
To set a fire the entire alley so that the riot really gets going.
Fuck them, am I right?
Yeah.
Okay, the alley is now on fire.
This riot wasn't hot enough.
Emiria, you rapidly begin to reconsider your choice of spells as the buildings to your left and right light on fire.
My choice of spells all day, pretty much.
Mm.
It's not been a good day for me.
However, your fire does not reveal where Red is.
Well, that sucks. Because that's the end of my turn. I put my hands on my hips and reconsider.
You could spend a mythic point to cast a different spell that might, you know, put out the rising fire.
Cone of fire.
Cone of fire extinguishing.
Cone of water.
Well, no, it would be control weather, and I'd make it rain, probably, be as far as...
Make it rain. Hey, that's a great idea. Rain, when it rains, there's less rioting, usually, because people get wet.
Because who else rioted in the rain?
Didn't even know that was a mythic thing.
That you can expend a spell... It depends on which...
Oh, yeah, you might not have taken that.
I went with Wild.
Yeah,
I went with Wild
Arcana. But I don't know if you can. But there's a certain, like, mythic...
Yeah,
you can pick 3 different things, and one of them for me was just pick any spell,
If you chose Wild Arcana, you can, like, cast any spell in your spell list.
Yeah, for a Hierophant, it's a different word, but it's the same thing.
As an aside, though, a spell in a Cone of Cold would counter your Cone of Fire, or at least put the fire out. Like, cast in the next round or so.
Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, the riot gets worse.
What? How does a riot get worse?
Aristus, you have made your way outside of the arena.
I feel good about myself.
I
do have Wild Arcana.
A number of people are trying to get away from the riot, which is beginning to spill into the square next to the arena.
I should care about that.
A large number of guards are rushing towards it. and are trying to force the rioters back with truncheons.
Hmm. That sucks.
A few of them are... A few more well-armed guards, armed with partisans, are forming up in front of the arena in ranks.
So they're in my way?
Hmm. Yeah, kind of. They're trying to stop people, the rioters, from getting in and damaging the arena more than they're trying to stop people from getting out, though.
Well, as long as they're not in here with me, they're out there.
Yeah. All right. The guards are basically forming a pike wall.
Hmm. Hmm. I don't. Cool. I don't know what he wants me to do here. Like, I don't want to interfere here. It's not my authority. Is there a window I can, like, jump
find
through?
A garbage can and go to sleep.
No. Is there a wall I can climb over?
There are various stores on the far side of the, and bars and things that are rapidly trying to close.
I just realized I could probably jump over this riot.
The whole riot?
Yeah, I jump really, yeah. I'm just a very...
Aristus is gonna jump!
At this point, the riot is covering, like, a square mile.
Aristus is
a TV.
I'm just like, Aristus is gonna jump at the Medium Riot!
And Aristus
just gets on a skateboard.
I want to leave the arena. I'm still in the arena, right?
You're at the gates of the arena, or one of them.
Alright, I'm going to jump over the guards. I'm going to jump over the pike wall.
Alright, roll jump check.
Alright, one second.
You land on the pikes.
Let's see, that's acrobat, right?
Yep.
Acrobat's is 23.
Plus 10 because of the ring of jumping.
Huh?
Oh wait, you don't have that, never mind. Okay, you casually do a triple front flip over the pike wall. One of the pikemen commanders go, "Hey, wow."
Later, fuckers.
And nobody tries to stop you, as they're too busy trying to prepare for stopping the riot, and also too really impressed. Like, a couple of them start clapping.
Hold up signs with 10 out of 10.
Mm-hmm. The Russian guard only gives you a 6.
I crack my knuckles.
Russians in the Dominion.
I crack my knuckles and I pull out my trident, just in case.
Why?
Okay.
I'm not good. If somebody, like, comes my way, they're getting stabbed. Nobody messes with a guy with a giant fork. Or a crazy guy, I guess.
Frood, you very rapidly get to the palace. As you are flying over the city, you get a bird's eye view of the rapidly growing riot. You also see, like, a sort of military complex far up the avenue that's on. The gates of it are opening, and a large number of men on horses are beginning to ride out of it.
Who are those guys?
The First Legion of the city provides helps provide security and protect the capital against attack. Those would be its cuirassier regiment.
First Legion? You haven't even retired that number yet? You guys would do pretty well militarily.
Wait, how does that even work? Yeah, that's... How the hell is it the First Legion?
No, it makes sense to be the First Legion, it's just...
Does that mean they've never been defeated or something?
Well, I mean, it's not that they don't retire numbers when they're never defeated, but generally, like...
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what the criteria for retiring a number is.
Are they,
The 45th Battalion is doing good. I don't think it's time to retire them yet.
retire the Legion's
number. They go for another season, at least.
Rome did do that.
4 more years.
Rome did retire legionary numbers. But that was usually when they got really badly, like, fucked in a battle, and they thought that it was bad luck to keep fighting under that.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
So...
Anyway.
If it's the first... Nerd. If it's charged with just defending the capital, though, it may have been a long time since the First Legion has actually seen combat.
Ooh.
Which would contribute to its longevity.
Political intrigue instead of exterior threats. Okay. So they're gonna go try and fuck up some peasants.
I would suppose so.
So while we're up here, is your pappy dead? What's up with your pappy?
I told you, dying of cancer.
Is he, though?
Oh, yes. This very is, much so.
What kind of cancer?
The ass cancer.
Okay. Aristus, I drop you out of the call.
His strength has been failing for weeks now. Okay. It is really, really quite sad.
Single tear goes down his really
a single
fast.
And it's
multiple chins.
It becomes a raindrop. Loud.
What usually should take seconds to reach the ground takes minutes, hours to go down his multiple paces.
Because it's so heavy.
I'll be right back. On my turn, I'll put out that fire.
No, because he's so fat.
Okay.
Okay.
It evaporates far before it actually gets to fall off his face.
Right. So the first legion's going out to clear up the rabble.
Mm-hmm.
How many of those guys are there?
Oh, I've never really had such a mind for military matters. As far as I'm concerned, I can leave that to other people who are far more competent than me at it. But I believe the number's something around 500 in the Kriviskos.
Is that going to be good to tame the slave revolt or whatever? Freeman revolt?
Well, you'd see men on horses charging at you have a tendency to make you run away.
Yeah, they do.
Not me.
You know, if you get one of your wizards to cast change weather and have it rain, that statistically has been shown to greatly reduce the risk of riots.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh. Right. Some Ardanian information I had not yet acquired. Thank you, my friend.
You're welcome.
This is
I shall remember this when I am emperor. It will no doubt become very handy.
Whenever the farmers need their crops watered, better start a riot. Alright, do we arrive at the palace?
You do arrive at the palace because you fly at 60 miles an hour.
I drive a Ferrari.
Your Maserati does 185. They took your license, though, and I drive.
My other ride is a windwalk.
You land in the courtyard, or one of the courtyards, the one outside of your apartments. Do you unwindwalk yourself?
Yeah. I don't know. I look around. Is the courtyard threatened?
No, not at all. It's quite quiet. You can't even hear the riot from in here.
Yeah. I put it in park.
All right. The four minotaurs go and pick up the Polonius's palanquin with some strain. And Polonius goes, I thank you, my friend Urab, for rescuing me from that riot. I am truly in your debt now. I shall make it up to you. I promise. It shall be lovely. Aha! Aha! Quickly, I think it's time for dinner. I'm sure my brother Aurelius has something suitably appropriate planned.
It's always time for dinner.
Come along, then. And the Minotaurs start bearing him towards a building.
Should probably find my friends.
And Aristus.
I shall leave that up to you, Rob. Thank you again.
No problem. Actually, can I? I should check. If for windwalk, can I just dump people out and then continue windwalking?
Sure.
Yeah. All right. Then I just like turn this baby around and start windwalking, surveying the city, looking for. Oh, look! There's a giant fire over there. I wonder if that's where the champions are.
Yes. You fly towards the fire.
Yeah.
Right, you reach it, and that'll be the end of your turn.
Okay.
Atenket.
Yes?
Atenket's all by himself.
You are...
Oh, yeah, I've got Solaris.
Oh.
Holy shit.
Okay. So what's up?
You are rushing through the inn chasing after people, I think?
No.
Oh, wait, no, you're carrying the guy to the hospital.
Yeah, Castellarius
is carrying him to the hospital.
Two Kessler.
Carrying him to the palace where Urab is, but now Urab's there.
I start spinning my double axe really fast.
To make it fly faster?
You accelerate Castellarius very slightly. The Castellarii are going as fast as they can, but he does not have the fastest fly speed.
He passes, Urab passes him as he goes to the fire.
Castellarius, the Castellarii wave at Urab as Urab goes past.
Wait, we need to get him. I try to flag him down.
What, with, like, cones? Like, airport?
If we're flying past him.
Urab, do you stop?
Because
you see them.
Sure,
you definitely see them.
I reverse, I do a quick U-turn, and I fly up by Castellarius, like, hey, what's going on?
This guy got shot.
Damn.
Bummer. Drop him. Yeah. Who cares about that guy?
Heal him. If he lives, the riot stops.
Yeah, isn't
no,
he,
that's
yeah.
not true.
He's the guy.
Yeah, Atenket, that's really not true, but I appreciate your naivete.
Heal the guy.
He is the guy.
He's like a kid. He's fucking didn't do anything wrong besides want more rights.
Yeah. All right.
Now I might go bring some steps to help calming it down.
I guess. Cure light wounds on him.
He wanted to achieve his vision through peace.
The guy's wound closes, although it's still rather bloody, still rather raw looking, and he opens his eyes. And he starts screaming when he realizes he's all the way up in the air.
He falls and dies.
This guy is screaming, says Castellarius.
Put him down, Castellarius.
What, over
gently?
I don't know, anywhere. Who cares?
Alright, I'm just going to put him on this roof, then.
Yeah.
And he flies down to a roof. The other Castellarius follows you, follows him with a ten cap. And you are currently, all three of you, on a roof.
I've changed gear again. Back into second, reverse, third, fourth, zoom back over to the fire.
Alright. You're now at the fire. You see a pit, a bunch of black tentacles, Emiria next to a large fire in an alley, Odell like covered in his own blood on the ground, and Silva on a spectral horse just sort of standing there.
You were gone for 20 minutes!
Also, the gendarme lieutenant has just run up onto the screen as well, into the scene as well. And is demanding where the hell the where the fugitive is.
Who? What?
He has made his escape.
She kicks a rock.
Is it the one that Silva summoned?
I get it because of homophones.
Silva, what did you do?
This was actually not me. It was a Mario mate who set the building on fire. I didn't make the.
Why did you set a building on fire?
I didn't make the pit though.
No, I mean like the riot.
Oh, I do not know some man that Odell seems to have recognized.
Where's Odell?
So, he is there, covered in his own blood.
Never made any outward sign that I recognized the person. Well, you were there when I. Did you hear anything when I was talking to him?
No, but I presume Silva can use the logic that you might have recognized him.
Oh, hey, Odell, I cast heal on you. You get 150.
Odell, you feel much better.
Because you were talking to him the whole time when Silva was watching you, so.
That's what I wasn't sure if you were at that point in time or not.
Yeah, Silva, you weren't there when he was chatting with Red.
Yeah.
Well, he saw some of the conversation, I think.
Silva arrived after Odell was knocked to the floor by the by Red, like trying to massacre him.
I think he arrived slightly before that.
No, I'm pretty sure what Sal said is correct.
Mm-hmm. It was a summon knife attack, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, regardless.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Anyway.
Nitpicks. It's pick nits. I cast heal on Adele, and he's got 150.
At this point, I think we can go off turn order.
I cast Cone of Cold.
Okay.
Instead
the
of
fire goes out.
Also, I expend a mythic when I do that. Boom. I did it. The fire is gone.
Mm-hmm.
I high five Silva. God.
Caught Nuva's disease.
Yeah, no, sorry. I've had it for a while now. But
you drink 7 Up.
Perhaps we should make our retreat now.
Perhaps, but what happened, Silva? Odell?
I told you.
You told me a guy.
A man wearing a gendarme uniform, or partial gendarme uniform, shot a protest leader, leading to a riot.
Okay. Do you guys want to go to the palace?
I'd like that.
Gendarme lady, you gonna stay here?
My name is Hanalyn.
Hanalyn, sorry. I mean, I didn't know.
But I am supposed to remain by your side.
Okay, great. So that's a yes.
I could just probably teleport us.
Yeah. Teleport or... What, have you been to... We've been to the palace,
yeah.
Right? Okay.
We've been there a ton. We spent a week there.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Well, let's
I teleport away.
Wait, Emiria.
I leave Emiria standing there in her fugue state.
Greaves said that he would cast Cone of Cold when in its turn he said he'd be away. I'm just going to assume we take Emiria with us.
Yeah.
Okay. The gendarme will actually grab Emiria and teleport with her. And the rest of you, I guess, again, just sort of figure out where you go.
I grab everyone else and teleport.
Mm. You're currently in the palace courtyard.
Where am I right now?
You're
in the riot.
Jumping over that wall.
Yeah, you're currently sort of like on the periphery of the riot, in fact.
Oh. How is that?
as we're teleporting, it's like, are we forgetting something?
Well, Aristus, you've sort of just been maneuvering through the riot. People haven't really been messing with you because you're not wearing a uniform.
Okay, cool.
As you are sort of currently to get your head above people, you are standing on a cart. Mm-hmm. And you have giving you a perfect view of a line of cavalry, which is currently trotting down the avenue towards the riot.
We're going to have to break Aristus out of prison again.
I cough my hands together and shout.
Don't, dude.
It's the law!
Oh no, Aristus.
The rioters closest to the cavalry are starting to like either stop or slowly back away from them. A few of them are like picking up rocks and stuff.
This is hilarious to watch.
While the rest of the rioters are just sort of doing their rioting thing. The cavalry has all drawn sabers, and from this distance you can see that they are heavily armored with breastplates and tall, gleaming gold helms.
Okay. Aristus, quick, organize the rioters into a phalanx.
I clearly can't let this happen anymore. Let's see what I can do.
Don't fight the cavalry.
I'm not going to fight a cavalry. I'm going to try diplomacy for the very first time.
Since, do it.
All right.
Monumental
device. I shout to the top of my voice. Let me think.
Stop
okay?
the fighting!
I assume that I'm going to...
Let him talk.
Okay. I'm going to need to be very careful with what I say here. Let me think.
Well, I mean, not really, because it's just the role, but yeah.
Well, I mean...
What he says might grant circumstance bonuses.
Sure.
Yeah. What's the name of this place again?
Don't get
Dominium.
Upset. Have some
Dominium.
Spaghetti.
My fellow Dominiums. I understand that. Whatever.
Go ahead. Keep going.
I understand that you are angry. I understand why you riot, but do not throw your lives against the mighty forces laid before us. You will be cut down and your lives wasted. We didn't understand what happened. You need to... I implore you to go back to your homes where it's safe. As to the law, allow for the rioters to disperse, please. Do not attack them.
Roll diplomacy.
All right. 1 second. SMS. Okay.
Bless you.
Thank you. What's my diplomacy?
I was yelling at God when he turned this 15. down. All right.
Perfect timing. Ooh, good roll. Wow, really good roll. Well, unfortunately, the law, as you were calling them, is out of earshot.
Wow.
So you're somewhat unsurprised when the cavalry starts picking up pace. However, a large number of the riot had quieted down quite a lot once the cursors became visible, and a number of them listened to you. And many people are rapidly, like, trying to get into houses or just into the side streets or alleys, just generally trying to get out of the avenue and main square that the riot had been occupying. And overall, a lot of them have calmed down. So by the time that the cruisers reach them on a full charge, there's only a few really hardline agitators still in the streets, chucking rocks at them, trying to beat them off with logs or detritus or whatever else they can grab, and being cut down mercilessly as the Dumedain cavalry cuts them down like stalks of wheat.
Oh well,
Darwin. You saved a lot of people.
Yeah, the equivalent of Darwin exists in this universe is being proven right as right now.
Or at least.
He's proven right no matter what.
Yeah. I assume now I can go home.
A gendarme stops you, having just teleported to in with a number of other gendarmes. They're appearing in force, actually. There's about 50 of them that just teleported into the main square and are busily arresting people or exhausting them or doing all other manner of things to get the remaining crowds under control.
Mm-hmm.
A gendarme appears next to you and says, "I saw what you did."
Yes.
Who are you?
I am Champion Aristus, guest of the Prince Polonius. I'm the guest of the Prince.
His eyes widen a bit at that, and I had been told that one of the visitors from Ardania was a Gilman, but it... Sir, would you like me to comport you back to the palace?
Yes.
All right. There will be a certain lurch. He takes you by the shoulder and teleports you back to the palace.
Cool.
You're currently reunited with your friends just as they are going, "Didn't we forget something?"
Hello, everybody.
And that's the end of tonight's session.
Done.
Yay.
We fucked up the entire city.
That didn't take long.
A high five.
We also everybody. Didn't get any information regarding who we should support.
Nope. I say we support that red guy.
No.
Just destroy the Dumedain Empire.
God.
Fuck them.
Give it right over to the beast that writhes. Here you go. Here's the keys.
So yeah. Today you were reunited with an old friend.
Hell yeah.
You got to see a gladiatorial match.
I got to knock people over with a river of wind.
Yep. I got a 10 out of 10 on my jumping skills. Except that one guy who scored me a 6.
5.
Whatever.
I found out Scylla was really useless in a non-lethal situation.
Are you kidding? You were fantastic.
Okay.
What are you talking about?
Well, that river of wind and that charm person, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. You
and like color spray.
But yeah. Particularly the River of Wind, that kept you guys on the stage from being swarmed.
Hell yeah.
I learned how Red managed to kill all those people that one time.
I learned to love again.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, if we actually got swarmed, I would have just killed a bunch of people.
Oh yeah, jeez.
Yeah. Wait. And you'd been having to deal with horde damage, actually, so it would have been a problem.
I mean, I should have done an irresistible dance on Red instead, but I was like, the irresistible dance is like a guaranteed success.
Mm.
Even though it wouldn't last very long.
It is irresistible, as they say.
Yeah. Because I think, like, the, at most, it can only last one round.
What, last one round?
Irresistible dance.
Yeah. Like, I can, at most, of it, if they, like, succeed in everything and I roll really low, it will only last for one round. Like, otherwise, it can last for a maximum of five. But that's why it's also really good, because it always will be at least one round.
Okay.
Yeah. We did it. Did we level?
You did not level, no.
Damn.
You will get experience, I will tell you later.
Okay. It's a good thing we didn't get into a fight.
Actually, no, you didn't really have any real monster experience, so I can just give you an arbitrary amount.
Yeah.
500,000.
Yeah. Yes! Perfect.
No. It's a good thing we didn't get into a fight yet, because I've yet to pick a skill, a new skill.
I will give you 12,000 experience for today each.
Woo. Okay, let me just do the math.
I will continue to not acknowledge what these numbers mean.
My throat.
Oh, I'm sorry. It seems that what I have is contagious.
Yep, threats for the internet.
I apologize for coughing.
It's an internet virus.
So you got 12,000?
Yes.
Okay. We now have,
Hey.
Let me just take it out.
Hey. Tombstone. Hey.
What?
I have 48.
What? Oh, yeah, and FF14.
And I have 43 to 49.
Nice. That's how much experience we have now, by the way.
25,000. Wait, I don't know how to read this number. 250,000 out of nearly 500k. It's ridiculous. I really hope that when I hit 49, the events that I'm doing, the XP I get for them triples.
Mm.
Or something. I don't know. I don't want to wait.
You'll find out.
Apparently I filled up half of the challenge log. That's very easy to fill.
Nice.
Yeah.